Okay, now the participants are coming in. Sir, if there is any issue, you call me because I might be in office, so you can call me.
Yes, sure.
Ma'am, you may go. It's 350 participants now.
Okay. Good afternoon, all. I, Dr. Bhumika Barot, on behalf of the Department of Education, the Maharaja Sayajirao University of Baroda and the IUCT, welcome you all to the second day of the webinar on CyberGogi for 21st Century Classroom. Let's begin our today's session by remembering the goddess Saraswati. I request Dr. Jyotsna Amin, Assistant Professor, Department of Education, for invocation. Dr. Jyotsna.
Thank you, Dr. Bhumika. नमस्ते शारदे देवी काश्मीर पूर्वासिनी त्वामहं प्रार्थये नित्यं विद्यादानं च देहि विद्यादानं च देहि मे ओम शांति शांति शांति.
थैंक यू वेरी मच डॉक्टर ज्योत्सना फॉर अ श्लोका. मे आई नाउ रिक्वेस्ट द पैशनेट इनोवेटिव एंड रिस्पेक्टफुल प्रोफेसर आसे पटेल हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन डीन फैकल्टी फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड साइकोलॉजी एंड कोऑर्डिनेटर ऑफ आईयूसीटी टू एड्रेस द ऑगस्ट गैदरिंग. Sir, please.
Namaskar, good afternoon to all of you. I take this opportunity, though virtually, to welcome all of you to our second day of our reoccurring meeting of the webinar on CyberGogi for 21st Century Classrooms. This has been organized under the aegis of Inter-University Center for Teachers Education. This is a center established under the scheme of Pandit Madan Mohan Malaviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching at the Department of Education of the Maharaja Sayajirao University of Baroda. This IUCT, that is the Inter-University Center of Center for Teachers Education, has been actively organizing various events since last 2 years. To be very specific, this is the second webinar in last 1 week only. So without taking much of your time, on behalf of Honorable Vice Chancellor of our university, on behalf of all the staff members of MS University in general and Department of Education in particular, on behalf of my IUCT team and the organizing committee, I take this opportunity to welcome all the participants who are 509 at present, who are watching directly or who are connected with us directly on Zoom, and there are many more who are watching us on Facebook. So I welcome you all, and my special welcome to Dr. K. Thiago Suri. He would, in fact, he likes to be addressed as only Dr. K. Thiago. Dr. K. Thiago Suri is from Central University of Kerala. Sir, welcome to this.
Welcome. Thank you, sir.
Webinar, and we are looking forward for a very interactive, interesting session from you. Thank you, sir. And
thank you, sir.
Welcome you all once again.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. May I now request Dr. Jyotsna Amin to introduce our today's resource person, Dr. Jyotsna Amin. Dr. Jyotsna Amin, please unmute yourself.
Thank you, Dr. Bhumika. Today we have with us Dr. K. Thiago. Dr. K. Thiago is working as Assistant Professor in Department of Education, Central University of Kerala. His academic excellence includes 4 master's degrees, dual MPhil and NAET, each in mathematics and education. His doctoral work is in the area of e-content development in mathematics education. He has 13 years teaching experience in the university department. His professional portfolio boasts of 45 international and 80 national paper presentations, 72 research papers published in international and national journals. He has rendered his expertise in training teacher educators in various 42 workshops. And to name few workshop titles, it is Web 2 tools, Web 3 tools, mobile learning, e-assessment modules, Moodle LMS, U-learning, and so on. Seven of his research papers fetch Best Research Paper Presentations Award in various international publications. His work is also acknowledged by Google Scholar ranking. So we are happy to have you as a resource person. You Thank are you. The icon for the youth. I request you to begin with our first session on Web Tools for Collaborative Learning.
Thank you so
Over
much.
Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. So now I'm going to share the screen. So I can start my presentation with one activity. So I request the participants to be kindly participate in that activity. I hope all of you get my screen. So I'm sharing the link for this activity because my entire session is based purely on the interactive mode. So that's why I'm going to start my presentation with one activity now. I request the participants kindly give a response in the meeting. Actually, there is a code, it's called meet.ps. So you may have found out the code meet.ps/cybergogi. So I request the participants kindly come with that. You can go to the browser and type meet.ps/cybergogi. Then immediately you may reach this page. You can wait. So activate the queues. It's not a queues. Actually, it's like an activity. How we can make the collaborative activity with the students as well as the teachers, how we can be make the classrooms more lively. For this, this is some demonstration I'm going to do now. I request the participants kindly come for that. So that link is meet.ps. I hope all of you get my voice clearly, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. So if you want, I will type the link in the chat box. So please kindly
sir,
come
yes,
for
that. Please. This.
meet.ps/cybergogi. So this is a code. So meet.ps/cybergogi. Only 13 people are joined now. So now 16 people are joined now. So once it comes to 30, I can start my activity. After that, you won't be getting any kind of questions and all in your mobile phone or in any browser. You won't get anything because I have not activated anything now. So now the 25 people are joined with that. So 31 people. Now you may see from my screen. From there, you may found out here in the free version I'm using, nearly 1,000 people can join with this kind of activity. Now I'm going to conduct a small survey related to 3 questions only, because in the free manner, we may get a single activity for three questions only in the free version. Yes, so nearly 43 people have joined. The remaining person also kindly join with this. Yeah, so if you want, I will type the link now. So meet.ps.
Yes, sir, you please type on the chat box.
Yeah, yeah. So I will do it. meet.ps/cybergogi. Cybergogi. So yeah. So now I'm sending with one link in the chat box. So once you click, otherwise copy the link and paste it in the paste in your browser. Automatically you may connect with this page. So now the first question I'm going to be activate now. The first question, rate your proficiency to integrate online tools for your teaching and learning. This is the first question for you. Yeah, so now I'm going to show the result also parallelly. Yeah, so from this you must know how many people are good in the proficiency to integrate the technology tools in your teaching and learning. I got nearly 55 responses. Out of 55 responses, yeah. So 65 responses I got. Out of 67 responses, 13% of people, 12% of people are very good. So they given us a 5-point rate. It means that they are very good to utilizing the online tools for the teaching and learning. Nearly 38% of people said that they are good in utilizing the online tools for teaching and learning. Nearly 42% they highlight that they are moderate level to using the online tools and all. I already sent Kausal Tindra. I already sent. So otherwise there is an, I already sent the link in the chat box, meet.ps/cybergogi. Yes. Now I'm going with another question. So the second question for you, the second question now I'm going to activate. Yes, so the second question for you. The waiting, mention any two of your favorite tools. So you have to mention the tool's name only, then after that you can submit. Don't type in a big sentences and all, like for example, WhatsApp, Google Classroom, like that you can give the response and send it. So I got only one responses from this. I could know that Edmodo and Kahoot. Yeah, so now three responses I got. From this, we can know that how what are the tools you are, most of the people are familiar with this. So from this, I could understand that the Google Classroom, most of the people are using, because you see that some of the fonts, some are just big in size. Come to the case of Google Classroom and Kahoot, somewhat big in size. It means that this and tools, most of the people are using. It's like a frequency. If most of the people are giving the same responses, they may get, we may get the somewhat big in size answer representation from here. So I got 72 responses. So thank you so much for providing the responses. Now the third question I'm going to be activate. I'm going to be show list of tools now. From this, you have to be highlight which are the tools you are familiar. Which are the tools you are familiar? You have to select five tools. What are the tools you are familiar? Yeah, so I hope you may get the third questions in your screen. Third question you may get my screen, yeah. So give a response, any five tools, which are the tools you are familiar with you, that you have to highlight to me. Yeah, so some of the people are Wacklet, Jamboard, yeah, Flipgrid, yes, and Jimkit, Kahoot, Socrative. So some of the people are not familiar, and Tudela, only few people are knows the Tudela. From this we can know which are the tools are most of the people are familiar with this. So nearly 28% of people are knows the Meeting Pulse, 16% of people know Slido, WebEx only 9%, Mentimeter nearly 17%, Wacklet only 7%, Testies 13%, Jamboard 21%, Mural, that tools none of the people are not using. Then Padlet, so nearly 24 people are using. Flipgrid 18%, Nearpod 12%, Jimkit 3%, Kahoot. So most of the people knows about Kahoot, that's why I'm skipping. Because I like to give the demonstration, but most of the people are already familiar with this Kahoot. So if it's time possible, I will do the demonstration, otherwise I will skip it because most other people well known these things. Okay, now this is called as a synchronous discussion. Actually I'm not talking, I'm not doing the demonstration now. Once based on your idea, based on your answers, I'm summarize the things. So don't worry, when you go for my demonstration, I will go very slowly. See, in this case, now I am activated the survey. Parallel, you are giving the response. It's called a synchronous. For synchronous, you may know that the two kinds of online discussion. One is called synchronous discussion, other one is called asynchronous discussion. Synchronous means the key term is called real time. Real time teaching and learning happen. That is called real time. Otherwise, it's called synchronous. So here, I'm conducting a polls in a synchronous mode. Just I'm going to highlight how we can make the classroom more live in a collaborative manner. There is an option in ideas. I hope all of you get my screen. This polls for the synchronous mode. This polls for the synchronous mode. Parallel, there's ideas. If you want to make the classrooms more collaborative, just I'm going to ask a single question, but nearly 500 people are on the screen. So you are going to give your own responses in my screen. So for example, if I ask this single question to my, I have the 50 students in my classroom. If I ask a single question to my students, if you want to be cover all the 50 students, if they want to give the response, it takes 50 minutes. It takes 50 minutes. It means that the entire hours to be over. But I'm going to create a small activity now. I'm clicking the ideas. From this idea, there is some thing is called new brainstorming. I hope all of you know that what is a brainstorming. Normally in the classroom, only teacher may teach much. Only one brain may work. But if you give the platform or if you give the space to the students to interact or contribute their idea, that is called brainstorming. It means that all the brains of the classroom is to be working together, then it's called brainstorming. Just I'm going to ask one question. How to make the classroom more lively? So this is a question I'm asking. More lively. So this is a question I'm going to ask you. Now you are going to give the response from your end. So here more than 117 people are connected with me. Here the discussion may happen in this within a minute. Once I click save, okay, see here and down there is called save settings. once you click, automatically you may get the questions in your ideas. Those who are reach my nearly 120 people are there. I request the participants, those who are connect with meet.ps/cyberguagi, click the ideas and you may find out my questions, how to make the classrooms more lively, give your responses and submit.
Sir, participants are not able to see the chat box. So would you please highlight the meet, this one? Meet.ps.
Yes. Okay, this is a link. See here. Meet.ps/cyberguagi. That white color mark I put, no? Yeah. So once you click, I got two responses. See here. So once you click the meet.ps/cyberguagi, you may find out in your mobile screen or laptop screen four options. One is called ideas, Q&D, other one is called polls, then fourth one is called pulse. I request the participants to click the ideas. Then once you click the ideas, you may find out the questions, how to make the classroom more live. So you have give the responses there. So once you give the response, automatically I may see the responses in my screen. I got 25 responses here. You may find out the numbers here, 33 responses, 34 responses. If I click here, I can see the entire responses of each one. Interaction, good discussion, odd humor, then group discussion, then collaboration, demonstrations. Like that, lot of people are giving lot of answer on it. By relating to live experience, very good. Then involvement, use collective intelligence, then group discussion, interactions, ice-breaking activity. I got 67 responses here. I got 67 responses. This is called collaboration. Here, each students are collaboratively are given their answer own responses from there. This is an activity I conduct in a synchronous mode. I hope all of you get it. What is a synchronous? Because the teacher's screen is live. Parallelly, you are also giving your contributions. I am reading your comments also. It means that the teacher as well as the students, both are real time. They are interact with each other. Then it's called as a synchronous mode. So we can use this kind of tool for connecting the students for the collaborative synchronous mode discussion. Here, the students are giving the answers in the same screen in a collaborative manner. But if you give this, for example, see here, I've got 104 responses. If the same response, if you get in that regular classroom without the technology assistance, at least it takes half an hour to collect all the 100 students' response in a paper or they stand and highlight in the sense. But within 2 or 3 seconds, 3 minutes, I got 109 responses. All the responses you are seeing from my screen. See here. Make use of TPACK model demonstrations. So due to the time constraint, I could not be read any all the things. I hope all of you get it. What is the advantage of this kind of tool? This tool make the classrooms to be more live. Even these tools, they're making free for 1,000 people. It's a free version only I'm using. Those are conducting any kind of, now the most of the people are going with this kind of video meeting only, video conference meeting only. I request the participants, I request the host, at least the before the program or the end of the program, in between one activity. You can organize this kind of activity. If you are incorporating this kind of activity, that interaction more lively. The people also feel that, oh, so they are making the session more interaction, more lively. That kind of ambience we can make it through this kind of tool. Next thing, there is a Q&A. I already mentioned that there's 4 options are there. I'm going with the Q&A. If I go click and say Q&A, this is for the question and answer. This question and answer, even the teacher's not present also, you can ask the questions to here. This is called as an asynchronous mode. Whenever you have the questions, for example, my lectures to be over. Tomorrow also, you can collect the same code, meet.ps/cyberguagi. What are the doubts you have today, class you attend? No? From this, what are the doubts you want to be asked to me? You can open it tomorrow. You can ask the queries in the Q&A box. Whenever I'm opening, I can see the entire questions there. There I'm giving the responses. So this Q&A is option for discussion, going to the discussion in here. Asynchronous mode. So I hope all of you get it. Here some other people are asking how to make the classroom more lively. They send the same question by different task. So yeah, so what they did in the question answer only for like a discussion forum. We may hear the term discussion forum. if you have any kind of questions or the answers, if you want to tell to the students or you want to share your learners with your peer group members, you can use this kind of tool. So now I'm moving to my presentation. So this activity, I'm going to close this one. I will demonstrate how to create this tool and all, don't worry. So now I'm going to be click the end meeting. So once I click end meeting, no one can get the questions from your end, because the every control with the teachers have in their hand only. Now I'm going to my presentation. I'm going to my presentation. So this 45 minutes, I may talk about the this one, what is that? Web tools for collaboration. Otherwise, I'm going to start my presentation. Yes. So I'm going to little changes the topic. I'm going to highlight the interactive classroom collaboration tool also. Some of the tools also make perform, what is that, particularly may use for the interactive only. Some other tool they using for collaboration purpose only. That's why I mingle both the things. Before going to my lecture, just I'm going to be show how we are facing the lockdown, the 2.0 and 3.0 and 4.0. So yesterday onwards, we are in the 4.0 status in the lockdown. And this was the memes I get it from the social media only. Thanks to the social media. Because if I want to make the classroom more live, I want to incorporate some kind of humor, or I can incorporate some kind of memes. These are the memes developed by the students community. So how they make the memes, see here. So these things we know. Now most of the people are working with your homes only. The coronavirus is outside of our home. We are in the inside. We are working a lot for our future generation students. But see here, the reality of the Zoom meeting. If they conduct only the audio only, in the sense, no one can think about that backup things and all, dress code and all. They may comes like this. If they start as a video based interaction, in the sense, the people may comes like this. Yeah, so online lectures be like. So most of the time, we could not know what is the opportunity happen. So only I am teaching in front of the computer. I don't know whether you are listening or not in your end. So this is the biggest problem now we are facing the video conferencing meet. But in your end, we could not predict what you are doing there. See, some of the students, they may be asleep. We are teaching only to the computer. This kind of thing also is going on now. Now, this is a thing you may get it, you may see in the social media site also. The BBC News, the news reader reading in the home. He's doing the work in the home itself. A lot of family commitment, a lot of family disturbance may come, even though we can be finish that particular task assigned from the organizer sites. This kind of things also we are causing now. Yeah, next thing, these are things, even you may cross some of the people's, they won't bear the proper dress code while attending the video meeting. And some of the people, they may lie down in the bed, they may hear the, they may attend this kind of video conferencing and all. Yeah, so see here next. So me in a Zoom meeting, mostly the people's may sit in the Zoom meeting like this, but if you see that exact dress code, so they won't be wear the exact dress code and all. Next, some of the people without knowingly, they may be share the screen. And sometimes they're chatting some unwanted things without, because some people, they want to explore know the particular tools. Without knowingly, if they share the things, or actually if they share the things, that time all the people can view the screen, in the sense they be, the people reaction may like this only. Next two things, when you want to stop meeting to end. So most of the times, they fix the time limit up to 5:30 or 6 o'clock. The end of the session, some of the people may ask the lot of questions. Okay. The in between, they're not opening their mouth and all, but the end of the meeting, they extend 5:30 into 6:30 or 6 or 7 o'clock. That kind of scenario also is going on. And there is a chance, cause of death, because now the particularly in the teacher community, we are daily attend at least one or two web conferences like this. So these are the memes created by the students community only. But if the video conferencing meet, they start in morning 10 o'clock, in the sense, some of the people, now the entire lifestyle are changing. The people may sleep in the midnight 1 o'clock, they may wake up 10 o'clock only. But some of the organizers, they may organize the program 10 o'clock. That time, how the people come and attend the meeting. See here, So unfortunately, this organizer, they organized the program in the 3 to 5:30. That's a good turn up. Otherwise, the people without brushing, without bathing, they may come and attend the program. Yeah, so now the, our life is goes into 24/7 access with computer or the mobile phone devices only. Mobile phone devices only. We are spending the time much. So see here, this is also another reality, particularly the teacher fraternity community. We are working a 24/7 access. Previously, we are working 10 to 5. There is a time limit to other, but nowadays, we are morning, we are attending the program, evening, the night also, some of the online program is coming. Yeah, so everywhere the webinar is going on. This is the case sometimes when you conduct some webinar, some issues in your net connection, so you may left from the meeting. That time the students may react like this only. If you are host the any meeting without you, the students are so happy. Because they have the lot of freedom to talk to their friends and all, because they are also connected with the friends after a long time in a virtual. Therefore, they are interacting in a very good manner through, if you are the teachers, not in the live. Now I move to my task now. So this is the way we are crossed down the lockdowns. Yes, so now in the collaboration, I can divide the collaboration tools in four ways. How the teacher to collaborate, teacher to learner collaboration, learner to learner collaborations, and teachers to learners collaborations. So this kind of things. So I'm going to talk about what are the tools is available for teacher-teach collaboration, teacher and learner collaboration, teachers and learner learner and to learner collaboration. This kind of things I'm going to talk. Here I'm talking about the teacher and learner is a singular. I put as in teachers and learners. So it means that more number of teachers, like a team teaching, 2 or 3 teachers, parallelly 50 students, they are collaborate each other. Some of the tools I'm going to highlight. The first thing, first I'm going to highlight the tools name, then after that I'm going to the presentation. The interactive presentation tools, we can use this kind of tools for our class to more lively, like one is called Meeting Pulse, WebEx. So just I'm going to be summarize the tools name, after that I'm going for demonstration. Otherwise, I'll not be continue properly. That's why I'm going to be highlight the tools name. After that, I'm giving the demonstration one by one. These are the tools is very much good for to classroom making as an interactive mode. Even we can class making the classrooms more interaction also. The tool name is called Meeting Pulse. Other tool name is called WebEx. These tools, they make it for 100 people only free, but these tools for 1,000 people at a time, they may make it work. It Meeting Pulse for 1,000 people, WebEx only for 100 people. Some limitation are there in the free version. The Slido is also nearly 1,000 people, we can use it, but only the condition for each activity, we can create only 3 questions only. This is called interactive presentation tools. Next, if you want to, for example, if you use the Google Meet and all, there is no whiteboard option, but in the Zoom, there is a whiteboard options. There we may connect with this. Suppose you are using only the Google Meet tool, video conferencing tool. If you want to write some mathematical formula and all, it's not easy to teach the mathematical things through the video conferencing. That time you can use this kind of interactive whiteboard tools. Even 5 teachers can collaborate. They can be give their own contribution to the same board, or even the students also can give the responses in the same board. That tool name is, you know, that Jamboard. That first tools Jamboard, it's already in the Google Drive, it's available. The next tool is called Twiddler. This tools, what is the advantage? Like a wiki. We can use for the whiteboard as well as the wiki. We can develop a website also parallelly. A lot of flexibility they're providing, but in the Jamboard only for the whiteboard only. Yes, when I go for demonstration, I'm going very slowly, don't worry. Now I'm highlighting the tools name only. The tools names, I will share my, the entire PowerPoint to you. Because the reason only I'm going to be a little faster, because I'm going to highlight the names only. When I go for demonstration, I'm going very slowly, don't worry. The tool name is called Jamboard. Other tool name is called Twiddler. I will share the entire presentation. Yes, yes, I'm going to little slowly, yes. The second tool is called Twiddler. This also like an interactive presentation whiteboard tool. Is making the classroom more lively. Here, for example, I'm creating a whiteboard. If I share the whiteboard to my co-teachers as well as my students, each one can write the same thing in that same whiteboard. Apparently, there is a wiki option also there. I hope all of you know what is wiki. Wiki is nothing but it's a collaborative web pages. If you want to develop a collaborative web page, we can adopt this kind of wiki techniques. These tools, they're providing the wiki service also. If you share that particular web page to the students community, each student may contribute their own idea on the same page. So this is an advantage in the Tudla. Next is called Mural. This was the same kind of collaboration tools, but in interactive whiteboard tools. Here we can add more number of visual representation like a chart, then lot of diagrammatic representation things we can be adopted this kind of tool. That tool is Mural. This tool is to be free only for some limitations are there. If you go with the pricing mode, we may get lot of options, but in the free mode, some limitation is that I may highlight when I go for demonstration. The next tool is called Kakko, C-A-C-O-O, Kakko by Nulab. This also another tool. We can make the classroom in a diagrammatic way. We can even, that's like a whiteboard, I already mentioned that. But this whiteboard is like a flow chart or the diagram representation way to class make the classrooms more lively. But the live should be in the manner of real time. I already mentioned that it's a synchronous mode. The discussion may happen through this kind of tool. Yes. Next thing. So these are the tools I'm discussing about the whiteboard, interactive whiteboard. Next, I'm going to talk about. Each tool I may explain, sir. So first of 10 minutes, I can find what is that highlight the all the tools name. After that, I'm going one by one to demonstration. Next tool is called collaboratively content development tool. For example, now in the higher education, what they're doing for a single paper, a single course, nearly two or three teachers may divide the papers. For example, first unit, one per teachers, second unit, one teachers. Like that, we are dividing the papers. If you want to share that entire material to students in a collaborative with the team-based teachers, we can adopt this kind of tool. Like one is called Google Drive. Even the Google Drive, we know that Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides. That even the Google Slides also, for example, now I prepared my PowerPoint by myself. But if you're using the Google Slides, there is a two or three co-teachers. That teachers also may contribute. They can modify my PowerPoint. They also given some input on my PowerPoint. That kind of mechanism they're adopting in the Google Slides, Google Docs and all. So it means that we can develop a material with our co-teachers. Next tool is called Wacklet. It's like a compilation of our material. Save, organize, or share our content across the web. But the main advantage of this tool, even for example, I'm teaching for only first unit of research methodology. That first material and the first unit, I have some material. Suppose the second unit taken by the second, another teachers or your colleague, what you have to do, just to share that link to them. They may contribute the second unit material in the same site, the same collections. So finally, you can collect all the faculty members' material, then you can share to your students. So here, we are collecting the material in a collaborative manner. So that tool is called Wacklet. The same thing, same mechanism, they're adopting the test teach. This is a tool for making a digital lesson plan, but we are making the digital lesson plan in a collaborative manner, not in a single teacher we can make it. If you want, make it a single teacher by yourself, we can make it. Otherwise, we can share the link to our students. We can invite the faculty member, co-teachers. They also may contribute their idea or thoughts in the particular resource materials. So we know that it's called Google Classroom. In the Google Classroom also, there is an option is called collaborative, invite the collaborators. But most of the teachers are not adopting, but some of the states they are adopting, some of the institutions are adopting the co-collaborators or the invite the collaborators. If you invite the collaborators, even you are the course instructor, other teacher also may contribute some material for that particular course. So this mechanism they are adding in the Google Classrooms. If you need, you can adopt this one. Next is called Edmodo. This is also a LMS platform. There also, we can create a co-teacher. They may give their own contributions. They can give them some other resources other than use share to our students. Like a collaborative way, the teacher may share their materials to our students. Next tool is called, this tool is very unique in the sense, this is called VT tool. What is the advantage of this kind of tool? So these tools, the VT, the short form is VT, but the exact name is called VoiceThread. VoiceThread.com, the URL of this tool is called VoiceThread. Here we can make it a collaborative content, easily collaborative content through voice, through video or image based, and we can share the content later to our students. But here we can easily make it some video content or audio content in a collaborative manner also is possible here. Now the next tool, Podio. Podio is like a Edmodo only. This also like a LMS platform. We can assign some project work to our students community or our co-teacher community. They may work together to complete the task. That's called Podio. Is a website based tool that provides a social media like experience to collaborates who wish to share informations, documents and collaborate as effectively as possible. This kind of possibilities available in the Podio. So I highlight nearly 5 tools related to the content development in a collaborative way. Next, how we can make the classroom more lively through the gamified tools. But this kind of tool also we can use for the collaborative purpose. Here the collaboration happen to the students. Like if you want to, yesterday also you may hear, the Joseph may talk about the Qsys app. The cues is, no, we can conduct the game in a group mode, otherwise in a challenge, what is it? Classic mode. Classic mode means each individual can participate. But in the team mode, the participants can give the responses, but the responses, it will be, gives the, gives the input for succeeding the groups. It means that the students are actually participating the task in a collaborative or in the group manner. That kind of tool I'm going to be emphasizing now. One is called Padlet. That also we know, the collaborate better, be more productive. So this tool is available, web tool as well as the mobile app also. That also I'm going to be do the demonstration. Next tool is called Flipgrid. This tool, what is the advantage? You know, normally we are, previously I given some demonstration about the Meeting Pulse. The Meeting Pulse is a tool only for text-based interaction or text-based collaboration only. But this is Flipgrid, it's a Microsoft company only is providing. They are providing a free one only. Here, the people sharing their idea or thoughts in a video mode. They fix the video up to 5 minutes for the free. Even for example, now we are facing the COVID-19. We are worried about how to conduct a YOS examination and all. So here we have to tell the students to present the content, present the research work for 5 minutes and submit the reports through this kind of platform that is called Flipgrid. Here, the students giving the responses in a video mode. Next tool is called Nearpod. Here are some of the lot of engaged learning activities inbuilt is there. As well as the collaborative task we can assign to the students. That also is possible here. Nearpod, I will demonstrate once I come for the case. The next is Kahoot. Most of the people are already familiar. It's like assessment tool only. But even though we can make the classrooms more lively with a group-based game than single game. Otherwise, even the students may contribute their own questions there. That kind of collaborative mechanism they are adopting in the Kahoot. Next is the Gymkit. It's a unique tool. What is the advantage? No, we can, the students may, normally the Kahoot and all, the students may not give the questions. Only the teachers may create the questions. We can organize the cues. But here, the students can give the questions. Then after collecting the question from the students, we can organize the cues to the entire students community. That kind of mechanism they're adopting. It means that the students collaboratively are each one sharing their questions to us. Once you admit the question, then finally we can go for conducting some kind of online cues and all. That mechanism they're adding the Gymkit tool. Next tool is called Socrative. This also online examination, but come to the case of the previous tools like Kahoot and Qsys, you know, we can conduct only the objective questions like multiple choice question or true or false. But in the Socrative, we can conduct 2-mark questions, 5-mark questions, all the questions we can be organized. If you want to conduct some online examination with some descriptive based, you can adopt this kind of tool. But this tool having some like a rocket rush, that kind of mechanism they are adopting, that features is called as a gamification features. That also I'm going to be highlight. Next is Qsys. Yesterday the Joseph may talk about it. It's maybe assessment tool only, but maybe assessment. But when you go for the group-based, team-based activity, then it's called as a gamified collaborative. Because the students are attempt the task in a collaborative or group-based. Therefore, we can use this tool also as a collaborative task. Yeah, now I'm going to the tools one by one demonstrations. Yes, the first tool, I'm already mentioned the meeting pulse. So the meeting pulse tools I'm going to be highlight now. How to create a meeting pulse tools. Yeah, so just I'm going to be close this one. What you have to do, so I'm just to go to the google.com. I'm going to the google.com. Once you go to the google.com, type meeting pulse. The tool name is called meeting pulse. Meeting pulse. If you click the meeting pulse, then that URL ID is called meet.ps. The URL ID is called meet.ps. Once I click the meet.ps, I already having a lot of URL I already developed that. What is the advantage of this kind of tool? No, but if you go with Slido as well as the WebEx, no, we may get the code. We may connect with the activity, the code only. But this meet.ps, no need to be connected with the code. Just to copy the URL and paste. So the students may connect with the URL itself directly. So if you want to be create an account, go with a get in free account for the first time users. I'm already having the account. Therefore, I'm going with the login. Those who want to be get an account, go with the get in free account. Only the condition, as a teacher, we need the account. For the students, no need to create an account. The students can participate any activity without having the account. Yes, see here, I already have this much of meetings I conducted. First thing, how to create a meeting. So once you reach the page, the home site of the meeting pulse, go with create a new meeting. Once you click the create a meeting, it has the URL. Just I'm putting as a demo CyberGogi. This is a URL ID, meet.ps/demo CyberGogi. If I click create meeting, it shows that if it no one can use this kind of code, in the sense it goes to the next level. Otherwise, it shows the red color mark. We can modify the URL ID. Yeah, now see here, now it's moving. It's seen that the URL ID is free only, so no one can adopt it previously. Now, after giving the URL ID, go with done. So this asking that with this all the features are available, ideas, Q&A, polls, survey, and pulse. Pulse is nothing but the feedback of this event. So after completing the entire event, the students may give the pulse, like a feedback of the organizing the event, that is called pulse. The video mode, the free version is not available. That's why it's not be enabled. Only the ideas, question A, poll survey, and pulses to be enabled for the free version. Idea is nothing but the brainstorming. Question A is for the asynchronous mode. Polls and survey for the synchronous mode. I hope all of you get it. So you can verify the settings now. After that, go with done. Once you click the done, yeah, so it goes to the that home, I mean, your site address. See here, this is our site address. The right corner, in the left corner, we may find out the site address, meet.ps/demo CyberGogi. This is our URL ID. What you have to do, just to copy that URL ID and paste to our students. Once you type the questions. Okay, now I already mentioned that the ideas is for the brainstorming. If you want to get the open-ended question, if you want to conduct some open-ended discussion, you can go with new brainstorming method. Suppose if you want to conduct a closed-ended poll survey, go with the polls. Go with the polls. Then another option is called Q&A. The Q&A is an answer for the asynchronous. Whenever the students having the queries, they may ask the questions in the Q&A options. The pulse is nothing but the feedback. Once the entire process to be over, the students may give the responses in the pulse. Yes, now I'm going with the polls. Just I'm going to create here one question. I'm clicking the polls. Once you click the polls, it asks to create a new poll. I'm clicking the create a new poll. If you click the create a new poll, default, the single answer features may come. Once I click it here, a lot of options are there. One is called single answer, means a question having a single, only one response. Multiple answer means a question having the two or three more responses. The preference order means, for example, I'm giving four responses. Do you like idli, dosa, vada, like this? So if the students want to give the order, the preference order, which one they like much, that kind of question you can go with preference order. There is another feature is called yes or no. This is called yes or no, means only the two, do you like technology? Like if you want to ask the close-ended question with the two responses, yes or no, you can candidate it. This is for free text. This is like an open-ended question, but the students can give only the one word answer, not in a big paragraph or not in a sentence. This is called only free text in a word representation. Next one is called numerical. If you conduct any numerical representation, you know, questions or survey, you can go with numerical. The next one is called rating. Like we may, in the research, we may know the 2-point scale, 3-point scale, 5-point scale. That kind of survey, if you want conduct, we'll go with rating. The NPS is for the facial reaction, like emoji. Emoji. This is called emoji. For example, I'm selecting the NPS option. Just I'm asking the question, how do you feel yesterday? How do you feel yesterday? So here I'm asked the questions here, but I fixed the NPS. NPS is nothing but the emoji based survey collection. Now people's move towards the rating based. So previously the people were using only attitude scale only. They are using the strongly agree, neutral, and all. Now the people's moving to the emoji based data collection, as well as the rating 5-star, 3-star based. Better to adopt this kind of new techniques for collecting the data also. The first question I type, how do you feel yesterday, but in the NPS format. Once you type the questions, go with down. There is an option called save poll. Once you click save poll, the first question is ready. Now the second question, if you want to create, click create a new poll. Now here I am asking the questions like free text. So here I'm asking the free text. Free text means open-ended question, but the students can give only small responses. Here the free text, I'm typing the question. So do you like, what is your favorite tool? What is your favorite dish? Okay, favorite. Mobile apps. So just we can ask that questions like this. But here the students may give the only small responses, the second questions. So like that, in a free manner, we can create for each classroom or each UR only 3 questions only. Now I'm creating the 2 questions. So up to this, I hope all of you get it, how to conduct it, how to post the content, how to create a questions and all. Then next task, how to organize it. So once the meeting is ready, you can tell the students to connect with this code. I request the participants to connect with this code, me.ps/demo-cyber-gogi. Already 3 people have joined. So I request the other participants. Otherwise, you can see in the screen, the 3 participants already there. You can share this link to the entire participants through the chat box or any way. Then after that, I'm going to organize now. What you have to do, there is a right corner, there is a start meeting. Once you click start meeting only, the students or the participants may get your survey tools. Otherwise, they won't get any kind of things. If I start meeting, they may get these screens. They may get their, screen, but the questions cannot be displayed because I'm not be display the questions. The participants can see the screen. So they may see the home screen of my me.ps demo, CyberGogi, but they could not be, see my questions because I'm not activate the questions. Now the 25 people have joined. Once I click start, now I'm going to click the start. Once I click start, the first question is visible to the participants in. See here. So now I click the start button. Once I click start, the questions, it comes the students in. If you want to know the results, the survey results, the left corner, there is a small arrow. There we can see from here, there's some responses. I got 22 responses. There's a 10 points emoji skills. Most of the people, they feel very comfortable for the yesterday. This was the first question survey. Suppose if you want to close this survey, there is an option called stop. If you stop, the students cannot be, after this, anyone cannot be give the responses. Now the first 2 questions to be over. The second question is called start. If I click start, the second question is move. What is your favorite mobile apps? Once I click start, in the right corner, in the left corner, there is a small arrow, the left side of the questions. If I click, that options may come. Once the students are giving the responses, the answer is come as a cloud-based. Google, Instagram, Edmodo, Facebook. See here, this much response is coming. I hope all of you get it, how to do it. This is a tool to make the classroom more lively, as well as the interact. This is called interactive personality. See here, the students are given their answer in an interactive manner. here I am seeing in my end, the students also seeing that other, what is that? The students also may get the, their, what they giving the response, anything they may see from their ends. Now, this is called poll. I already mentioned the poll section is only for synchronous. Suppose even I close this meeting, the students can ask the question Q&A. There's a 3 questions coming. Very interesting. Can you share the video? I will the people may share the video. This Q&A, I already mentioned, the Q&A is only for the asynchronous mode. That ideas I already demonstrate. Idea is for the, sir, meet.ps is not a mobile app. It is a URL ID. What you have to do, just to copy the link, meet.ps/demo cybergogi and paste in your browser of your mobile phone. For example, go to your Google Chrome and paste the link there, then automatically it may work. So it, there is no mobile app. It's working with URL ID only, but WebEx and Slido having the mobile apps. Yes. So in the ideas, I can ask the questions, open-ended question. I already demonstrated. That's why I'm skipping. If you go with Pulse, Pulse is nothing but the, see here, the Pulse is the feedback of the entire, I'm conducting some activity in the meeting Pulse, no? The people are giving the their feedback about the this kind of tools. Now I got 5 responses. All of the people are very comfortable with this and they feel very happy. This is a way we can get the feedback to the students community or participants community. Yes, so now this tool's very simple. I hope all of you understand this tool. Those who understand, put UU. I can move to the next tool. So those who understand, put UU. I go to the next tool to demonstrate. Yes, the end meeting, then click OK. Yes, now I'm moving with the next tool. Yeah, so next tool is Slido. These things you know, Slido and Mentimeter, these are things you know. That's why I'm skipping only. I'm telling the route only how to go with Slido. Slido.com, the tool name is called Slido.com. You can click the Slido.com. And here the people may connect it with code, not in a URL ID. So due to the time concern, I am not demonstrate. I will share my the blog ID. There you may find out my entire self-explanatory tutorial, step-by-step tutorial. You may get it. Finally, I will share my blog ID. This is called Slido. Then other tool is called WebEx. That tool is called WebEx. So this is another tool. This is the number one app in the 2018 number one mobile apps in 2018. That is called WebEx, making a virtual meeting, the class is unmissable in a collaborative manner. Yeah. Yeah, so Mentimeter, the most of the people is already familiar, but if you're adopting in the Mentimeter, now we can use only the 2 questions only, each events. But in the WebEx, there is no limitation for the number of questions. You can go with the n number of questions. That is called WebEx tools given. This is the number one. See that home screen, you may get it. There's a best award winner in 2018. And this tool only for education purpose they are making, not for the any other commercial purpose and all. So most of the people are using only for education purpose, not for the like business purpose and all. You can adopt this kind of WebEx also. The next thing I'm going to talk about how we can collaboratively, our teacher can collaboratively contribute their responses or share that content through the next, through the some of the application. One is called Wacklet. Just I'm going to demonstrate the Wacklet.com tool. Here the students, the participants, now the co-teachers, no, they contribute the content in a collaborative way. See here, I'm already having the account in the WebEx Wacklet. So this tool is called Wacklet. In the Wacklet, I'm already created this much. I'm going to create a new one. Otherwise I will log out. I will tell you how to come back. So if I come here, there's a logout option. So I'm coming from the first step onwards. The Wacklet, go to the Wacklet.com. The URL ID is called Wacklet.com. The Wacklet.com, I already having the account. Therefore, I'm going with the login. If you don't have the account, you can go with sign up. You can sign up with your Gmail account also. That also is here, they given the options. But I'm going with the login only. If I click login, it was the connect with the Google only. I'm connecting with my Gmail. And I'm request the participants. See here, I'm having plenty of mail ID. Tiago Surya, Saibet Tiago, Tiago Suri, like this. But whenever you are using any online tools, for example, daily we are learning a lot of web tools. But whenever you are sign up with a Google account, that account should not be your personal account. Like you may connect with your that Google account for your bank, than Aadhaar card or any kind of personal things, even for the organization purpose, you are using some mail ID. That mail ID don't be used because sometimes the hackers may hack your account. That's why better create a separate account. For example, I'm creating a separate account for this kind of online tools that is called Tiago MOOC. So it means that all the online tools I'm accessing with these tools only. Other tools, I won't use it. So if I open it, it may connect with my backlit. So because in the digital etiquettes, now you know the in the 21st century, we need a digital quotient. Like we know the intelligent quotient, emotional quotient like this. In the 21st century, much needed for the teacher community is digital quotient. In the digital quotient, we must know the cyber safety. So that's why better to use, don't use your personal mail ID for connecting with this kind of tools. Next, after this, I'm going to create a content now in a collaborative manner. See here, just I'm going to create a new collections. I already mentioned it's like a collection of material in a collaborative manner. Just I'm creating a collections. For example, I am the research teacher, research methodology, research collection. Like that, I'm giving the file name. Then if I click in the plus symbol, in that down there is a plus symbol you may found. If you click the plus symbol, we can add the material in a different way. We can paste the material, add text, even we can connect with YouTube video, bookmarks, tweets, image, upload PDF, Google Drive, OneDrive. Even we can connect with video. So everything is to be permissible. Just I'm going to do the demonstration of, if I click plus symbol, there is an option called YouTube. If I click YouTube, just I'm typing the key terms like research in education. So if I, lot of videos are there. I'm not downloading the video. If I download the video only, it's unethics, but I'm connecting with that material with only the link only. It's directly, I'm embedding the content. I'm embedding the content to my sites directly only. Therefore, for example, I need this content. Just I'm selecting this content. Click add. So automatically the content, the first content is the video. The next one is called, if you need another YouTube video, I'm going to YouTube. I'm going with type 1 error, type 2 error. I'm going to type 1 error. This questions I need in the sense, type 1 error. Select which video you want. I'm selecting this video. If I click add, the second video may come. So see here, the first video, like a resource, we may connect all the resources. I may compile the resources. I am the one teacher. So you can collect like this. So I can connect with in a different mode. We can paste some, for example, in the Wikipedia material, you can just type the Wikipedia content. Wikipedia sites automatically may connect. Then if you want to add directly some content from your end, go with add text. YouTube, if you want a link with the YouTube video, go with YouTube video. You have some tweets content. If you want to add directly, you can go with Twitch video. Like the plenty of way we can add the materials. Just for the demonstration purpose, I'm adding the two videos. Now after the two videos, I'm sharing that link to the my co-teachers. I'm going to share. So normally it's come as some private, I'm going to some public. So then after that, I'm going to be enable the copy. If you want to customize the background and all, you can go with add background images and all. That is called only the background color settings and all. Now after enable the copy and public, I can go with done. If I click done, next thing, I already added only two videos. There is an option you may get it that's called contributors. So here, if I click the contributor already knows that here I only added only two videos only. Suppose I have the two or three colleagues, they are also handling the same paper. If they want to add the same page, some content, go with the contributors option. Once you click the contributors option, we can you can share the link. There's a link just to copy the link and share to our teacher, share to our co-teachers. So once you click the link, it comes as an enabled mode, activated in editing mode. Even the people's may, what is the other co-teacher may add some materials there. Otherwise, the other options called via name or email. Here, some of the teachers are there. They are the followers. For them also, for example, if you want to send the Rekha Chauhan madam, just select and send to her. So like that, we can easily share the our collective materials to the our co-teachers. The co-teachers may work in their in or her or his end. He or her can contribute some contribute some materials in this. So I hope all of you get it here that we can compile the material in a collaborative manner. Then after compiling the entire material, what you have to do, we have to share to our students. Then here there is an option called share. Contributors only for collaboration of the compiling the material. If you click the share option, you may get the URL ID. This is an URL ID we have to share our students. Even this URL ID we can connect with our Google Classroom, Facebook, then Microsoft Teams. So a lot of options, Twitter, this much options are providing just to copy and share to them. I hope those are, and I hope it's very easy tool. Only it's a tool is called making or compiling the materials in a collaborative mode. Those who are understand, put UU. I go to the next tool. I hope it's a very simple tool. Just you can explore it. I will share the other, my entire blog content. There you may find out how to be organized, how to go with the step-by-step instructions are available. That's I will give to the end of my session. Yes. Now, just I'm going with another tool, Test Teach. This also another tool, the same kind of compiling the material, Test Teach with the Blended Space. That tool name is called Test Teach with Blended Space. The advantage of this tool, we can create a multimedia lessons within a 5 minutes. Very simple. Already existing content in the online resource, we are compiling the material. Just to select the left or right corner and track it in our slides. And you can conduct some quizzes also parallelly. Here there is an option login. If you want to create an account, go with sign up. You can sign up with your Gmail account also, but I'm going with the login. If I go with the login, it's also the login with the Google. I'm going with the login with the Google. I already mentioned that whenever you are connecting with your online tool, don't give your personal mail ID. I'm giving my separate mail ID particularly for this kind of online tool that is called thiagomook@gmail.com. I'm connecting with this tool. Once I connect with this tool, it goes to the homepage of Test Teach. It's a very simple tool, but it's very attractive also. I'm telling how to do it. So now see here, this is Test Teach home site. It's like same as a Wacklet, but here the teachers make collab. That's why I told here the teacher collaboration happen for this kind of tool. Yeah, so now I'm going with a new lesson. I'm going to create a new lesson. Therefore, I'm going to new lesson. Once you click a new lesson, like a PowerPoint slides, no? That kind of slides is come slide 1, slide 2, slide 3, slide 4. See here, slide 1, slide 2, slide 3, slide 4, slide 5. Like this slide wise is coming. Suppose I want to develop a emotion intelligence material. Just I'm typing the emotion intelligence in the right corner. There's a search box, emotional intelligence. I'm typing the title of the emotion intelligence. Once I type, the free versions are coming. See here, the emotion intelligence. This is for the Test Teach content. If you go with the Google content, in the right corner, all the content, this is for YouTube. Now the YouTube is not activated. You can go with the normal Google search. If you click the normal Google search, all the emotion intelligence materials are available. See here, this much of emotion intelligence. You can read it which you want. For example, what is emotion intelligence? That video is there. Just I'm selecting the video. Just a drag and drop option I'm doing. Now the video is ready. So that option, now the first content is ready. The next content, suppose I want to add this content, just as selecting, I'm tracking here, the second slide. So like that, just to select and track it, then immediately the people make, you may create a digital lesson very easily. Just I'm giving the title of the lesson, the top corner. Yeah, so emotional intelligence, that is a topic, emotional intelligence. This is a title. Suppose I want to get some images from the Google. Just I'm clicking the Google. Lot of images related to the emotional intelligence may comes. For example, this image I need. Just keep the cursor in the second image, track it, drop and down options. Then immediately may comes there. Next, if you need this image, just to track and drop. Like that, you can create a n number of slides. Okay. Now what I'm doing, I am making the content, then after that, what we have to do, so suppose you feel that the four things is enough. If you want to create a queues, there is an option called queues option. There you can create a queues. Otherwise, if you want to add the text by your own, you can go with create your own text. That is called art text. Art queues is for the creating a queues that you have to explore by yourself, because the remaining times I have to go with the other tools also. Then after that, I will tell you how to share these things to our co-teachers. There's an option called share. If I click share, see here, there's a three options. Okay, share, it is for the students. Share for the students. There is an option called collaborate. Collaborate. So here, for example, if I send the mail ID of my teachers, Tiago, another mail ID of me, tiagocvk@gmail.com. They are also having the same, this kind of text reach. If I send to add, it may reach the one mail to them. There the people can modify or edit, or they may add some content there. So I hope you may get it, how to do a collaboration. So once you click the share option, you may find the two options. One is called share is for the students. Then collaborate for the inviting the co-teachers to contribute their own idea. That is called teacher-teacher collaboration. I hope all of you get it, how to do a teacher-teacher collaboration to make the content, to make create the content. This kind of tool is be very unique for you. Kindly explore it. So I hope all of you understand this tool. No? Those who understand, put EU. I will share my the tutorial, the step-by-step tutorials available in my blog. There you may explore it. Okay, thank you. Most other people's knows. Now, two things I talk. One is called interactive presentation tool in a collaborative. The second one, how we can make the content or collaboratively development of the content through the co-teachers and all. Next, I'm going to talk about the interactive whiteboard tools. Interactive whiteboard tools, that tool is called Tudla.com. Tudla.com, otherwise Jamboard. Most of the people are familiar with Jamboard, but the Jamboard, what is the advantage, disadvantage, what is the features available only for creating a board only, whiteboard only. But here, Wiki is also permissible. Now, this is a thing they given the free trial for 30 days, but don't click the login as well as the sign in. Without the login also, there is an option called start a new whiteboard. So if you go with start a new whiteboard, no need for the 30 days trial and all. So we can start, but we could not be find out the student's name. We can find out the guest name only, guest one, some names may come. That only you may get it. So yeah, now I'm clicking the start a new whiteboard. If I click start a new whiteboard, it goes to the next screen. There, see here, the lot of options are there. Whiteboard is for writing the content. Here, if you want to draw, you can use the draw option. This for the erase. If you want to add some images, see here, there is an option, draw images. Just select and draw it, what are things you want. If you want to type anything, the text, go with text and type the text here. So I'm selecting the text. In which mode you need a text? So just to type the text. So yeah, here we can parallel do the discussion, the right corner, the left, right corner, there is a chat box also is coming. Only one guest is there, who is, that is my name, guest 294, it is my name. Then once you create this kind of board, you have to share the screen to our students. How we can share it? See here, there is an option called share. So if I close, nothing should be visible. Here you may find out the options called share, otherwise this code, see here, this is a code. Yeah, this is a sharing code. This code you have to be shared to our students community or your co-teachers. Once you share the code, suppose I'm sharing the code in our, so I request the people go with the tudla.com/kbzdfm. If you connect with this code, automatically you may get my screen. You may also contribute to your own idea. Please, some other people's connect with this code. The code I'm already displaying here. https://www.twiddla.com/kpzdfm. So once you come with that code, see here, the second person is coming, guest 6983, because we are using without sign up. Once they sign up, their names is coming. So what are things they're doing? The parallel we may get it. Yeah, see here, this much people are coming. Now nearly 6 or 7 people are coming to the screen. They are accessing my whiteboard. I request the participants, those who are coming, my blackboard. Yeah, see here, you can parallel see my, the people are writing now. Some people are writing like this. So parallel, what is the advantage? Once you go for Google Meet and all, this kind of tool is not available. So particularly in the whiteboard option, it's not available in the Google Meet. You can adopt, once you go for this kind of Google Meet, open this kind of tvidla.com, then you can use this whiteboard to transfer the content. Yeah, so would you like to join but cannot be because already 10 users present? Yeah, that is the thing. Because I'm using free version only. If you sign up, we can go with more than 50 people. So I'm not sign up because reason only 10 users are present. Okay. Yes. So people may be delete parallel also. Here the text mode discussion. If I click the text mode, the people, hi, how are you? Otherwise, you can ask the questions, anything. So the people may give the responses parallelly. Now the other people are writing something. They are deleting also. There is an option. If you go with whiteboard, there is a clear options. If you click clear, automatically all the things to be over. So this is called whiteboard. Next thing, etherboard. That is called etherboard. This is called as here. What is that? Wiki. Here I can type the, for example, I'm clicking the, please don't write anyone. I request the participant, don't write anyone. Now I'm creating the etherboard. Etherboard is like, wiki. So the people can give the answers one by one. In down, you can type it. So go with the browse mode. Once you go with the browse mode, you can type the content, please. Yeah, you can type the content one by one down. It is like a web page. For example, I'm asking the questions here. Write your opinion. Write your opinion about online tools. So people are online tools. So because each ones are writing now, that's due to the network issue, it will be deleting. Once it, people are typing, now some other people are typing. Yeah. So for each time it should be refreshing. Yeah, some people are writing, the answer is nice. See here, some people, Varma is writing. Like is a Google Docs. So we may know how to use the Google Docs, no? The same kind of mechanism they're adopting. So here we can, the students can contribute the responses by individual. What you have to do, otherwise this kind of disturbance may come. You can assign the number, for example, 1 to 5, one student. Then what is the line 6 to 10, one student. Like that you can assign the number to a student's community. Then this kind of disturbance won't become. This kind of information won't become. Otherwise this kind of disturbance may come. The better to be allot the numbers for each individuals. Then nothing should become. Yes, so it's very, now the people are typing here, the amazing, super, really very informative, nice to write your opinion too. Yes. The problem, they, all the people are typing the first letter, first itself, that is why. So I request the people, come to the 17 or 18, the line, you can type it, the answers. Because most of the people are typing the first line itself. That is the only the issue. So once we can, for our student, then we can easily control. We can allot the first number students only 5, you can type only within the 5 words only, within the 5, tab only you can go with. Like that we can allot the numbers. See here, now the people are typing in down also. It's a very simple tool, but make the classroom more lively, more interactively, you can adopt this tool. That is called tvidla.com. I'm close this one. So due to the time fact, I'm going to the next tool. See here, the tvidla.com. It's like an interactive presentation tool only. If I go with, this is my Google Drive. The Google Drive, lot of collaborative tools are available. Just I'm going to highlight the tools name. One is called Google Docs, people's knows. That's why I'm not highlighting. Google Docs is nothing but the Word file, MS Office Word. But here, normally in the MS Office Word, only we can be do the editing or saving and all. But here, nearly 100 people can collaboratively work. But we can share nearly 200 people together, but only 100 people only synchronously collaborate. Synchronously, they may do the edit work, 100 people only. That is called Google Docs. Then Google Slides, which is nothing but our MS, Excel sheets. If you want to collect some, for example, now I collect the students' internal mark to all my faculty members through the Google Sheets only. So make the Google Sheets, make the one Google Sheet and type the subject, each subject one sheet, you can create it and share the link to our faculty community and collect the internal mark from your student, from the teachers. That is purpose, we can use the Google Sheets. And if you want to collect some information related to your students, you can use the Google Sheets. And yesterday, the Joe sir may talk about the tool is called Certify EM in the Google Forms. Suppose if you want to generate a certificate in the Google Sheets, for example, here the even some of the people's, you may collect the information of the students' community or in the participants' community, the Excel sheet only. Here there is an add-on tool is called Autocrat. If you go with the Autocrat tool, go with the add-on. If you install the Autocrat, because for installation takes time, that's why I'm not telling. The tool name is called Autocrat. Yesterday you learned the tool Certify EM, that is for Google Forms, for making an auto-generated certificate. The same thing, the spreadsheet in the MS, in the sheets also available. But only thing, you can type the participants' names. Once you type the participants' name, automatically that certificate may be generated with Autocrat. That spelling auto, AutoCraft, Autocraft tool. The next tool you know that is called Google Slides. This is like a PowerPoint. Here, what is the advantage of this tool? Normally, people's very much familiar with PowerPoint, but here we can connect the tool, or the people may give the collaboratively fill the slides in more than 100 people together. But we have to share the link nearly 200 people in a free manner. But for synchronized mode, only 100 people is only me working in the Google. Now there is another option, because these things you know, there is a add-on software that is called Slido. Because if you want to conduct the interactive presentation, the morning I talk about WebEx as well as the other things, no? If you want to conduct a Slido directly in your presentation, go with add-on. In the add-on, get an add-on. You can type the Slido as a tool name. If you install it, you can conduct here some online interactive, like we can conduct, see here, the Slido is available. Just to give the add-on software, install the Slido, I already installed it. So we can easily organize here some kind of interactions very easily. Then here the Flipgrid, not Flipgrid, that other tool is called Nearpod. Nearpod also is available. So we can convert the Google slides directly to the Nearpod. That mechanism also is there. So better to normally what's our the people's doing, no? We are learning only the tools like Google Sheets and Google Slides and all. Better to explore the add-on software also, because add-on software is a third party tool. It's like a third party tool, but it's strengthening the tools, that origin tools like Google Slides or Google Sheets. It may strengthening that primary tools. So if you're adding some kind of add-on tools, surely the classrooms will be more lively. Like see here, the Nearpod, Kaizana, then Slido. So these are the tools if you're adopting while you are transacting the content through the Google Slides is very good. So I'm not highlighting because the time is very less now. Next two things we know that is called Google Jamboard. Yesterday that sir may talk about the Google Forms. These things you know how to generate the auto certificate and all. Google site is like a wiki. Google site is a wiki. I hope most of the people knows how to create a Google sites. But the Jamboard, only few of them may aware of it. The Jamboard is like a whiteboard. If you want to make the classrooms more lively in an interactive mode, for example, in the real classroom, only the teachers may write the entire thing in the blackboard. We are not allowing the students to be write anything. But here it's like a whiteboard only. We can add, just I'm going to be highlight the features only. This for fun features. You can write anything. Okay, you can write anything. This is for the fun features. A lot of colors are available. You can write anything. Then this is for the rubber erasers. Just select and erase it. This for the selector. If you want to select some images or any kind of text messages, you can select it. This for sticky notes. Suppose I'm asking the questions. So feedback about or opinion about collaborative tools. Collaborative tools. Just I'm asking the opinion, the spelling wrong. So opinion about collaborative tools. Just I'm putting the same. The questions may comes there. This is for the sticky notes. this options to select. So I can select at anywhere and keep it anywhere. This was select options. If you want to add some images, just I'm adding some images. If I go with add images, it goes to the upload images. You can go with select files. So you can find out the which file you want to be attached. Suppose I want to add these images, just to select the image and open it. Then immediately the image to be uploading. Then you can be upload the images in the site itself. Now the image is ready. If you want to be enlarge the images, you can enlarge the images. Actually, the people are confusing with what is my webinar. Actually, webinar is a word come to the two word, web plus seminar. Web plus seminar. If you are organizing a seminar in an online mode, in a virtual meet, then one is called seminar, webinar. But without knowingly, some people, they are giving some kind of workshop. They are using the term webinar only for the online seminar or through the web-based seminar, if you are organizing, then one is called webinar. So like that, we can add it. This is called laser. The last one is called laser. Laser, normally when you go for presentation, we are using laser point. No, this was a laser point. If you click the laser point, one red mark we can allow. So here we may highlight the points. For example, I'm rounding the webinar. So once you round, automatically the mouse goes. That is called, we may highlight the important points in the laser. That is for laser options. Then if you want to create the next page, go with the next create frame. You can create a number of frames like this. Then once you create the frames, if you want to share to collaborate, this is called collaboration, I'm telling. Give the name, I'm putting as here, Jam collaborations, just I put as a name. Then go with share. If I click share, it has the people's mail ID. If you have the student's mail ID in your group, just to share the mail ID, the entire group. For example, I'm sharing thiagocuk@gmail.com. If I go with thiagocuk@gmail.com, it comes there. It's I'm using another mail ID. I'm coming with this mail ID. Just I'm showing this how it will be comes to my mobile. See here. Just I'm sharing these things there. Yeah, so now it goes to the Thiago CUK. There I'm going to connect. So I already share. Now I'm sharing my screen. See here, this is my mobile screen. I'm sharing, this is my mobile screen. This is my mobile screen. There I'm opening my, discussion forum. Yes, I'm opening my Jamboard. I'm using the another account, see here. So if I refresh it, the second one is coming. Yes. So now it's refreshing. So the second one may comes there. So otherwise I go with Thiago CK, no? So yeah, Thiago Mook is there. I'm going with Thiago CK, another account. Now that, yeah, now see here, the Jam collaboration is coming here. So I'm coming with the mobile. It is a mobile view. I'm connected with another devices. It is a mobile view. It is a laptop view with another device. The mobile view, I'm writing something. So here I can write anything. I can mark it. Just I mark it. See here, I mark it in the browser here. It may comes there also. If I want to write any text, I'm clicking the plus symbol. I'm see in the right corner, the mobile view is coming. There I'm clicking the stick notes. Just I'm putting hi, hi, hi. I am putting here, that hi is coming here. So automatically it also coming here. So it may come, see here, the hi is coming. So as a teacher, I can, what I do, just I'm selecting here, I track it here. So the mobile view I close now. Like that we can be merge these things. This tools, it's very much useful once you use the Google Meet. So in the Google Meet, we don't have that kind of feature to write anything. So once you go with the Google Meet or even for making the classroom more lively, you can adopt this kind of tools. So I hope all of you understand these tools. Those who are understand put SSS, I'll go to the next tools like GymKit. GymKit is a very unique tool. I'm going to be highlight the tool. Yes, so GymKit, the tool name is called GymKit. Just I'm opening my mobile because I want to know the your view, no, sorry. That's why I'm clicking the, I'm clicking the Zoom view also. Yes, so now I'm getting the screen. Yes, see here, I already having the account in the Google and GymKit. Still now you may explore a lot of Kahoot and Socrative, a lot of application knows, but this tool is very, collaborative tools. Even it's like a gamification tool, but it's like one option is called continue with the kit collaboration. Kit collaboration, it means that here the people are collaboratively giving the questions, then after that I'm organizing the queues and all. Now I'm activating the continue with the kit collaborations. once I click continue with the kit collaboration, that options may comes. There's a two options are there. There is a two options. One is called team mode. Other one is called classic mode. That classic mode, I'm good. Classic modes for each individual. Here I already mentioned the gamification mode. For each question, the students give the responses. They may get some scores, but in a dollar. Now I'm activate the entire features. After that, I'm clicking the classic. Here I'm not adding any question. Listen, I'm not adding any questions here. Here you are contributing the questions. For example, the your students contributing the question particular topic. Then as a teacher, you can be accept the question, which question you want to be accepted. Then once you accept, if you get 50 question or 30 question, finally you can go for organizing queues. Just I'm going with classic mode. If a classic mode, you may find out getting the, I'm clicking the continue. You may get the code. I request the participants to come link with the code.
Hello? Hello, Thiago sir, your audio is not there.
Now is it audible, madam? Now is it audible?
Yes,
now
sir.
Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sorry. Okay, so without knowing, I may unmute. So I request the participants come with a Gymkit/play. It is a tool that people can give the questions. Like people can give the questions. Finally, we make organize the queues. So nearly only 4 participants can connect with this. Apparently, in your right screen, you may ask to give the questions. I request the participants, those who are connected here, you can give the questions based on the technology. Just you can ask some few questions, one question, each one. Just to submit your questions, each one can submit here one objective questions. Very simple question like ICD stands for, CC stands for, OER stands for. Like that, you can ask the small question. So nearly 19 people are joined. I request the people kindly submit your questions because nearly 21 people are there. If you have submitted the questions, because still now no questions are there. 28 players are there. Please, I request the participants, those who are connected with these queues, just ask some questions. Yeah, see here the first question. COVID is a virus, bacteria, pathogen. This is sent by the Maheshwari P. Maheshwari P sent one questions. As a teacher and I am accepting this tool. Therefore, the one question is ready. Can your student join through? Yes. So I'm adding this one. Or all these jobs are free? Yes. Add. Kahoot is used for queues. So this much, this question is by the Dr. Dibila Kohli. I'm accepting this question. Like that, nearly 4 people are giving the questions. 4 people are giving the questions. So here, the code is 96298, ma'am. So those who see the code, you may, the screen, you may get it. The questions from the Sonus UK. Which app is used to make the certificate? So very good. That answer is Certify EM. Very good. MOOC stands for this question from the Shipara. I am accepting the two questions. Like that, each individuals you are giving the questions. Yeah. Now the OBS stands for, very good, open source broadcast software. Next, ICD stands for this question from Deba. What is the example for software? Yeah, this from the Venkatesh GMU. Like that, each ones are given. So due to the time concern, I'm not adding all the question. Can I start the queues? Can I start the queues now? Because if you are each one giving 71 questions, 71 questions comes, I could not be wind up this activity. That is why. So each one, the questions coming, I'm adding that each question, the COVID is coronavirus, Geeta is question, Google Classroom is a learning from the Deepak Kohli. Like that, each people's, they are contributing the question. I hope you may get what is collaboration. Here, the participants or the students can give the questions by themselves. But previously in the go to the Socrative or the QCs, we only create the questions. But here we are providing the space to students to make the questions. What is the advantage? We can check these students' capacity of the mastery level of the particular content. Now the CSV file. Yes. Now I'm stop my adding process because if I adding much, I could not be complete this task. I'm going to start game. Still now we are adding the questions. just I'm going to start game. Immediately, the questions may display in your screen. You have to give the responses. Each questions, you may get some dollars, some applause and all. I'm going to start the game. Yes, now see the portion. You may get your portion also. Yeah, the game started. The first portion is go to Parul Puppet up to now. Yes, now the each one's, yeah, Praveen takes lead. So now the Praveen is leading. Then Parul Puppet is leading. So the game is started. The Praveen is, the Maheshwari P is second portion. Joshna is the third portion. Dhawan is fourth portion. Fifth portion is Jasubreet. Like that, each one portion in my end, I may see from here. Still the Praveen is takes lead. Still the Praveen is taking a lead. Good. Now the Maheshwari is taking a lead. Maheshwari is taking a lead. Here I can know the each person score also. If I click the Maheshwari, I know the Maheshwari scores. Then Dr. Pavi's score, each scores I may know. Yes, so now three. Now the Parul Puppet is the number one. Now the Maheshwari goes to the fourth place. The advantage, you may understand the advantage of true. I not create any questions. The questions also contributed by your end. And you are also participating in the quiz. So it is like a collaboratively, we can organize the quizzes or organize some kind of activity, but in a gamification mode. For each answer, you are getting some portions. Still, the Praveen is leading. Second portion goes to Parul Puppet. Yeah, now the Dr. Pavik, he is getting high level because of reason more power he is getting. He is getting money upgraded. Yes. Wow. So still, so can I wind up this game? Because more nearly 20 or 25 questions I added. So if I go with this, otherwise I give you 2 minutes time. Please complete fastly. Don't read the question, just to give the responses, because only for demonstration purpose only I'm conducting. I request the participants kindly for answer response very fastly. The code is already mentioned. Madam, once you started, you could not be connected with this code. Once you started, we cannot be connected with this code because I already started the event. I already muted the sound. Otherwise, you may get the applause sound. Lot of sound we may get it. Still, the Praveen is leading. Then second place goes to Sunil. Yeah. Second place goes to Sunil. Yes. Yes. Can I wind up? Can I wind up this activity? Because you are seriously participating. Now, is Uma is upgraded. Yes. So now I'm going to stop this activity. Now the end game. If I click the end game, we must know, we know the third place goes to the Madhika Das. Congratulations, Madhika Das. That second place goes to Maheshwari P. The first position goes to the Praveen. Congratulations. So now we may know the fourth position, Parameshwaran, then Kruti, fifth place, Sashwati, like that. All the positions of the people we know. If you know the reports, we can download the reports like QSIS as well as the Kahoot. So here, how do you feel about this tool? So you can give your, those who are under, like this tool, put LLL, like I'm onto the mobile apps next. So how do you feel? Do I think most of the people like this one? Yes, thank you. Can I move to the mobile apps, ma'am? So because already
thank you very much. Before starting our second session, I would request you to address the queries which are raised by the participant. Yes, it is sir. In a Q&A.
Okay. So you can read the questions, madam, because my end, if I close the screen, I cannot get it. So you can read the questions. I can give the responses. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
You can read.
Can I read?
Yes, ma'am. So one by one. So you can summarize because some questions may be repeatable. That's why. Yeah.
So one question is related. Which tools are useful to make video lecture interesting? As only recording of lecture.
Which tool? Yeah, record. Yeah. So yesterday that Joseph may talk about OBS Studio as well as the Screencastify and all. But in the next section, I'm going to talk about some of the mobile-based video content development. There is a unique tool is called Powtoon and Plotagon. Powtoon and Plotagon, it is a tool we can make it as animated video. Normally, yesterday that Saad talked about the Screencastify and Screencast-O-Matic as well as the OBS. No, we can make it our own screen. Only our screen it comes. One PowerPoint we can blend it. But here, we can create some avatar, like 2 persons standing and they are interacting with each other. That kind of interactive, interactive animated video we can use with the use of Protagon as well as the Powtoon. These are the tools. They given us a free, limited free version. Only the problem, once you develop, no, you may get some watermark, like in the Screencast-O-Matic also. Screencast-O-Matic also in the free version. Once you develop a video, no, we may get some watermark. No, that kind of watermark is available. That's only the limitations are there. And maximum 15 minutes video we make it through, like in the Screencast-O-Matic and all. Okay, but the next question, ma'am. So that tool is called Powtoon and Protagon.
Some of the participants want to know that how these apps is used for art, basically for arts faculty or teaching languages.
Yeah, that's why in the next section I'm going to talk about the separate application for language. Okay, I'm going to give some language applications, mobile app. Actually, people may confuse with apps as well as the web tools. I'm talking about web tools only. Apps in the sense mobile based only is called as an apps. Right, so those are downloading the things through the Google Play Store or in iOS, then it's called as an app, mobile apps. But in come to the case of web tools, means you are using through URL. With the URL, if you're accessing any tool, then it's called as a web tool. For the mobile phone, for the language users, there is a tool is called Tinny Cots. Tinny Cots, Duolingo.com. Actually, Duolingo is providing a, what is that? Giving the this is good for the language. Those want to be strengthen the language proficiency, they people may adopt this kind of Duolingo tool. Duolingo is in mobile applications, mobile apps, but Tinnikos Duolingo.com is like a flashcard, because normally for translating content in English we are using the flashcard only. Here I'm making one flashcard. So just if I open the flashcard, I'm creating the front view and back view. So here that questions coming, answer is coming. Like if you want to give some answer, questions in the front view, there's answer in the second view. I'm talking about the OER here. If I click the attribution, the answer CCBY is coming. The first slide, this is for first flashcard. If I go to the next second flashcard, I can go with continue. The next second image it comes, I can go with what is the image represent. Like that, you can adopt this kind of tool for the language people. That is called Tinnikots. Lot of applications are there. Just to Google it, what are the applications good for to developing that language proficiency? You may find out much. But this tool, we can transacting the verb, vocabulary skills to strengthen the vocabulary skills for students. We can adopt this kind of Tinnikots flashcard tools. Yes, ma'am. Other question, ma'am?
Other questions you have already covered during your session also, sir. Okay, let me check.
Yes.
Okay, we can start with our next session. That is on mobile application for education.
So now I'm close this entire thing. So now I'm close this one. Okay. Now I'm going to make the second PowerPoint, mobile apps for education. So just I'm close the other PowerPoint. Yes. So. Yes, all of you get my PPT now. So when mentioned. Yes. So I hope all of you get my PowerPoint. Here I'm not be go for presentation mode, because if you go with the presentation mode, my mobile I could not be able to demonstrate. Just I'm not going with the presentation mode. Parallel, I'm going to give the demonstration with my mobile view. So mobile apps for teachers. These are the applications good for the teacher community. You can adopt the for your teaching and learning also. The school of the features depends on the single device. School of the features depends on the single device, like a mobile only. Even if you have the iPad or any small kind of tablet, it's enough to be capture the entire thing. That's why we are moving to use much in the mobile devices compared to the, even if you take the survey, nearly 500 people are there. If you take the survey, nearly 80% of people, they are connecting this program with mobile only, not in a laptop. because that much of people's now the mobile having the plenty of features is coming because the reasons only the people's much adopting the mobile phone instead of the laptop and all. Now this terminology you may hear about that that is called BYOD, bring your own device. This is nothing but our laptop. And now see here, you are not using your institutional laptop or institutional mobile phone. Even the Wi-Fi connection also you are using by your own. That is called bring your own device. You are attending your program with your own devices. You are not depending on any of the, your institutional things and all. Therefore, it's called bring your own device. Even some of the institutions, they're creating one lab, bring your own device lab. There the students come with their own device, they may learn. They are not providing any kind of laptop or any kind of system facility. The students come with the laptop, they may learn and then go. Even in Tamil Nadu, when they join the first day of engineering college, the engineering college management, they provide some laptop the first day. They daily the students come with the laptop, they can access only the internet, then they can learn the things, all the material they may download it, they may interact with the teacher with the laptop itself. It means that the students are depending with their own devices. The first tool I'm going to talk about, the paperless classroom. How we can make the paperless classrooms with the use of these devices. Now I'm coming with my presentation. So see here, my mobile view is coming. I'm using the A-Power Mirror. That is a tool I'm using now. From this, I'm giving the mirror image in the laptop. I hope all of you get my screen. There, I'm going to be open the Evernote applications. What is the applications? I'm already put as a user fingerprint continue. Without me, no one can open it. If you, that kind of security options are available. The advantage of this tool, no, we can capture everything. Particularly whenever we are going to the classrooms, we are depending on some materials or some textbooks. So in the higher education, we don't be depends on the materials for going to the classrooms. Better to go with your mobile phone. That material, just you can take a material, like for example, I'm opening the plus symbol in the right corner. So this is, tool is called, most of the people are already familiar with this. Just I'm going to demonstrate how we can use it. If I go with plus symbol, this tool, there is an option, plenty of options are there. One is called text note, camera, then handwritten, attachment, audio, as well as the remainder. If you want to go with the text note, if you click the text note, automatically the text note mode, it comes here. The first I'm asking, typing the questions, so typing the content mobile apps. Mm-hmm. So once I type the mobile apps, here I'm typing the one by what are the mobile apps I'm going to talk. So here I'm talking about the Slido, then Mentimeter. So like that, you can take any notes here. Mentimeter. Like what are things you want to type? The problem, yeah. So the next, so you can type anything as you like. For example, what are things you want to share with your students? You can take say hints. Then suppose if you want to use some images also for your teaching, just to go in the top corner, there is a attachment option. If you click the attachment option, there is a photo option. If you want to add the photo in your mobile phone, you can go with photo options. Suppose you want to take a new photo, I'm clicking the take a new photo. I'm taking your photos of my laptop view. Just I'm select your photos. Now the photo is ready. So I'm skipping, sorry. Now I'm taking the photo. The photo is capturing. The photo is capturing now. So once the photo is capturing, I'm clicking the tick mark. The default, that image also has come to the same page. Like here, normally we are typing the content in the Word, no? The same kind of mechanism is there. We can use the images, we can use the text, then we can add any kind of files. For example, you can add some PDF file, Word file, any document. Even you can go with the recorded audio. Suppose you are sitting in some class, and that class is very awesome. Just to click the record video and capture the record video. Then if you want to write anything, the handwritten, go with handwritten features. The advantage of this tool, we can capture, we can like a compiling all our materials in our custody. So tomorrow you are going for class, for one class, just to open your mobile phone and give the lecture on it. So just I'm giving the content now. In the top, there is called note title. I'm giving as a demo, as a file name. It's a file name, it's a demo. I'm clicking the tick mark. then finally it's over. So now I create a file name as a demo. Here I'm keeping the content of tomorrow presentations. So tomorrow I'm going to make classrooms, open once again this tool. Then after this, the tool, just to open which file I want, I open the tool, I can present it. What is the advantage, extra advantage? For example, I'm creating, see here, the inspiring message. For example, whenever you are traveling somewhere, you may find out some of the good materials. That time we could not have the paper and pencil. Immediately, even during the traveling also, just so we can open your mobile phone, take your notes parallelly while traveling or while you're going flight also. Here I'm taking some of the good materials, inspiring messages. Whenever I'm going to give any lecture, just to open it, I can incorporate these materials while I'm giving the lectures. The another things, so daily we are creating number of applications. Here, if you open it, I'm using the username and password. Sometimes we may forget what is the username and password. I'm keeping all my bank details and all. But even though I put the bank details, I put for the thumb impression, then only the people may open. I have this much of materials. See here. All your personal things. Even suppose I'm going to give some president address, inaugural address, or welcome address. Normally, what you're doing, it depends on one paper or typing the content. But better, you can type your president address speech in your mobile phone before going to the meeting, just to open the
mirror
meeting. And you can give the lecture. You can give the lecture with the mobile phone itself. No need to depend on the audio, the paper. What is the advantage of this one? No, sometimes no. With our work schedule, we may keep the paper somewhere. We could not find the paper during the time of the program. Then we may fear. Then we may a lot of sorting may come and all. Better to keep all your materials in your mobile phone. Then it will be safer side for you. I hope all of you get it. So how to use this tool? This tool name is Evernote. Evernote, like lot of tools are available. Just I'm going to tell other tools like what are tools are available. The tool name is called ColorNote, OneNote, even the Google Keep also the same features available. Google Keep, Notepad, To-Do List, CloudNote, Notepad, ChromoNote Pocket. So you can adopt any kind of tool. Some mobile phone default is Evernote is coming. Some people, those are using a Google mobile phone. No? So normally we are using the Google Android mobile phone only. Automatically, sometimes the Google Keep is coming. You can adopt any tools as you like. There is no temporal to go with one tool, but I like the Evernote much because it's easy to compiling our thoughts, our ideas, and wherever we are going to share our ideas, just to open it, we can present it. That is the advantage of this tool. This is an advantage of this tool. Next tool I'm going to talk about now, the MOOC activity. So the MOOC activity based tools. So here, lot of tools are available. Just I'm sharing the tools names through my mobile phone, I'm already compiled the tools in a like a folder. That folder it's available. See here, the MOOC activity I put as a discussion forum. If you want to make the classroom, whenever you are running some kind of Moodle platform like Zoomia or Moodle Cloud or Google Classroom, you can adopt this kind of third-party tool for in connecting with you. Here, the I'm talking about the Slido, WebEx. This kind of mobile apps, mobile applications, making the classrooms more lively. Already I give the demonstration with Meeting Plus, the same kind of features available in Slido. This is a tools is good for to make the classroom more lively. The tool name is called Discussion Forum. I compile as a discussion forum. The one tool is called Nearpod. Other tool is called Padlet. For example, if the people giving the Padlet, automatically the Padlet should be opening. There is a three walls. I connected with this. If I click the My Blogs, this is my blog. My entire blog content, it will be linked with it. I give the hyperlink with that. So I'm basically mathematics. So all the mathematical contribution, Aryabhatta, Brahmagupta, Bhaskaracharya, Srinivasa Ramanujam. I hope all of you knows what is a Padlet uses. Padlet is nothing but the wallpaper. We can create a wallpaper. We can embed all our blog or any kind of things. Even we can collect the students' responses in a collaboratively with this tool. So here the entire my blog, then particularly for mathematics blogs in a single wallpaper itself. If the people click this link, automatically it goes to my blog. So that kind of mechanism I'm adopting. You can conduct for the discussion also. Suppose I'm clicking the e-learning demo. Here the pupils are already given some answer representations. It's an empty now. So please here, that question I'm asking, that write the some of the advantages of e-learning. The pupils are giving the response like this. So now they are given some of the tools names. The description you may get it. The tools names you may found out from here. And also list out the favorite mobile apps. They're given the responses. It means it's a collaboratively, the response we may collect in the mobile itself. No need to be depends on your laptop if you have the mobile itself. Only the thing, after making the tool, in the right corner, there's a three dot. There is an option called share, copy link, just to copy the link and share the link to the community of the group. Then immediately the people may connect with that code. They may participate with all the activities. That is called Padlet. Hopefully most of the people are already familiar with the Padlet. Just I'm skipping. The next tool is called Mentimeter. It's like a Slido. We can conduct here online survey. So if the people are clicking the Mentimeter, only the code may asking. From the code, the people may connect it. For conducting this game, you can go with the browser only. Only for students only they can be used this one. The students may give the code directly. That is called Mentimeter app. You can download in the Google Play Store. Once I install it, it talks to the code only. But as a teacher, you could not be use the Mentimeter app. You can go to the browser of your mobile phone. You can organize the event. But the students can connect with the mobile app itself. So this for the student purpose I'm talking. Next tool is called Poll Everywhere. Poll Everywhere. So this is the activity we can incorporate while we are teaching the content in the classrooms. So the Poll Everywhere. This also like a Slido or a Mentimeter or a Meeting Pulse. Here the people may connect with the link only, like in the Meeting Pulse link, no? The same kind of link they may connect it. But this, as a teacher, we can use the browser, not in a mobile app. Only the students may connect with mobile apps. So mobile apps, the people go to the Google Play Store and download the Poll Everywhere. What is the advantage of Poll Everywhere? Plenty of features are available, like in the plenty of survey features are available there. There the people may adopt. And that only the limitation, only 25 people may connect with this. Only 25 people may give that responses in one activity. For example, down there is an activity name, polyeve.com. Tiago Surya is already over. It's not be activated now. If I click also, it won't be goes to the next screen. See here. I'm clicking this one. Welcome to the Tiago Surya presentation. It now is going because I'm not activated there. But in a free manner, only 25 people may connect with this code. So connect with this link. I'm regularly using the poll survey. If your classroom is very small, because in the MED and all, we are only having the limited students. That time I may use this kind of tool for making the classroom more lively. The next tool, Slido, this already I talked to you. The next tool, WebEx also you know. Then Jamboard, importance also you know, because I already talked in the previous lecture. Next thing, Flipgrid. Just I'm going to talk about the Flipgrid, but I'm not give the demonstration previously. Flipgrid is a way to collect the feedback or collect the opinion about something to the students or to the participant in a video mode. See here, I'm opening the Flipgrid. If you open the Flipgrid, I'm already conducted it two times. One is called CAT demo, other one is called Tech Tiago. I'm opening the already existing content one. If you open the CAT demo, because I'm creating for one activity for one classroom, there is a 15 response I got. 15 responses. The 15 responses seen by the 104 people, 34 minutes are engaging. Here the participants giving the response in a video mode. See here the participant responses. Here the participant responses. Here the participant responses comes one by one. Now I already get the concern with the particular Porna because I'm using his content because I'm sharing now. I already get the consent because reason only I'm playing now. So his content I'm sharing you. So he already presented the content. What is MOOC? Yeah, he's giving the answer what is MOOC in his by own. Very good. So he's giving the answers like this. So like that, I got this much responses in a video mode. That's why I told the Flipgrid is a tool. We can collect the responses in a video mode. See here, I'm asking the question, what is MOOC? What is MOOC? This is a question I asked to the participants. After that, I'm sharing this link to the students and the participants. So in the participants, once they click the link, if they click the link, this link, they may get it. So the link is available in the site. If they want to give the new link, if they want to give the new answers, see here, there's a plus symbol. I'm clicking the plus symbol. Once I click the plus symbol, it does the login option for the particular group, particular student, because once they log in, only they may give it. Once they log in, automatically their mobile camera may open. They give the response one by one. So now the another videos I'm showing, for example, I'm get the consent with Jayanti madam also. She is the coordinator of this program. She is giving the response, what is MOOC? Just I'm clicking the answers up here. She is giving the responses. The problem with their audio end, that's why their audio is not clear. Yeah, so like this, he's given the responses. If you want to give some replay, I can give the replay here through the after login only. So, and I can give the mark also. So the, here we can see the number of people those are seeing, number of people those are seeing, number of people those are seeing the content, everything we may know. Here nearly 104 members already seen my content. Already seen my content, 37 minutes the content is available. The only that limitation is that the limitation of this tool, maximum they've given is a free version, 5 minutes. The people may give the 5 minutes, the content, minimum 5 seconds onwards. So you can adopt which one you want. Okay, it's a very unique tool. Here we can get the feedback from the student side in a video mode. It's better, for example, now the students have some hesitation to present their views. But now you are not organizing some seminar. We want to give that internal mark. What do you have to do? Just to create your own link like this in the Flipgrid. Present your seminar for 5 minutes. They can present their views within the 5 minutes. They may submit the seminar presentation in video mode. After that, you can give the responses, give the feedback, as well as a teacher, as the end of the teacher, you can give the feedback. So this kind of mechanism, it should be available in the Flipgrid. Next thing is called as a live board. Live board is like a jam board, but here we can easily create a board, whiteboard, and we can share it also. Once I open the that tool name is called live board. It is only the mobile based, not in the text website based. So once I open it, already I'm having 13 boards. If I click plus symbol, there's some two options, create a group, or a joint session. If you want to create a joint session, you can go with the joint session. If you want to create a group of members to interact with the same board, you can go with the create a group. The same mechanism of the jam board is they incorporating. Just I'm creating a new board. If I go the top, there's an option. Otherwise the default workshop, if I go with this, all the boards are available. There I'm going to create a new board. If I click new board, there is called a create a board. I'm clicking a create a new board. Here it's asking whether you need a landscape board or a portrait board. I need a portrait board. I'm clicking the portrait board and click create. For example, now there's some of the teachers not having the laptop in their hands. How we can connect with your students with this kind of live interaction board? You can use this kind of board like Jamboard or interactive whiteboard. Here the pencil symbol, that the images, everything's available like a Jamboard. We can add some images and you can write anything. You can add some text. What are things you want, you can add it. Then if you want to, this is the first page. If you want to add the second page, go with plus symbol, second page, third page. Like that, you can create n number of pages one by one. If you are exploring, you may get it. If you want to add some text, there is a text in down, text option in the down. I'm clicking the text option. If I click the text option is coming. I'm typing the text options. Which color you want, you can select the colors and type the content. So it's like a Jamboard. If you need to add the images also in the right corner, there is an image option. Click the image and take a photo or choose folder. Which one you want, you can adopt it. Okay, so these are the tools is good for making the classrooms to be more lively. So once again, I'm going to summarize the tools name. Nearpod, Nearpod is a unique tool. Here, Nearpod, even, sometimes, no, in the real classroom I'm talking, the real classroom, suppose in your classroom, there is no power or there is no internet. Even sometimes we don't have the LCD projector, but you want to share your PowerPoint to your students. What do you have to do? you can upload your PowerPoint in the airport. I'm not able to demonstrate now. I'm showing the students view only. And the teachers view, the teachers may share the PowerPoint, share the PowerPoints in the website nearport.com. Then after that, if they go with live mode, there is a code may comes. That code the people may connect with us. So the teacher may in the classroom, and they don't have LCD projector. The teacher, if you share that, if you change the PowerPoint, first slide to second slide, automatically the second slide comes to the mobile, the student's view. If they change the third slides, automatically the third slides come to the student screen. So it means that without the LCD projector, we can share our PowerPoint presentation with an airport. So this application is good for the real classroom. The real classroom way, if you want, you can go with an airport applications. Yes, now I already explained all the tools related to the discussion forum. Just once again, I summarize the discussion forum. Discussion forum Nearport for making the classroom, for engaging the classroom more lively. Apparently, if you don't have the electricity problem, you don't have the LCD, you can use this kind of Nearport to share your PPT. Parallel is a wallpaper-based interaction. Mentimeter is a survey tool. Poll survey everywhere also a survey tool. Flipgrid is like a video collection tool. Then Liveboard is an interactive whiteboard, Slido, WebEx, and Jamboard. This kind of tools we may use for making the classroom more live. Now I'm going to the next one. So the MOOC activity, otherwise, even you can adopt this kind of, even the MOOC, no, we have the four quadrant approach, but in the SWAYAM. The first quadrant is called e-text. The second quadrant is called, e-tutorial. The second one is called e-content. The third and fourth one is called assessment as well as the discussion forum. And that is why I'm emphasizing this kind of discussion forum as well as the assessment tool. This tool, if you're adopting, this is called as a gamification. This tool, once again, I'm just put this slide only, Slido, Mentimeter. But all the apps are available, even the Mentimeter, Aga Slides, Palette app. See here, there's a comparison for making to some humor as I want to add it. If you people are going with the toilet with your mobile phone, it takes 5 minutes only. If you're going with the mobile phone, it takes 15 minutes. If you're going with Wi-Fi connections, 55 minutes. If the people is going with the charger or the power bank, no way to be come out from the end. So that is the way we are, technology penetrated into our day-to-day life. The next tool is Nearport, Kahoot. Still now, we are using the normal textbook. Within 5 or 10 years, our normal textbook, we may kept in the museum. That's why the book without batteries, we may kept in the museums, books without batteries. Yes, so now I'm not able to find, getting the chat box questions because I'm sharing the screen and the mobile screen. That is why I'm not able to see. At the end, I will give the response for your questions because in the mobile view also I'm sharing. That is why I'm not able to get it. Then QC is operative. And there is a chance if you go for any interview, sometime that panel member they may ask the questions. Do you have any leadership skills? You can probably announce them. Yeah, I have the WhatsApp admin because nowadays for acting as a WhatsApp admin is a very big task, particularly that coronavirus time, a lot of policy information is coming for resolving. Some of the people are putting the political information, the religious information. So we could not be controlling the WhatsApp group. For controlling the WhatsApp group as acting as admin of WhatsApp is a very big task now. And it's very great thing. Now, previously the WhatsApp group only 256 member only. Now in the Telegram and all, 1,000 people also is there. So I don't know how they are controlling the 1,000 people in the Telegram apps. Because we can control easily 250 members, somewhat is okay. But controlling the 1,000 people in the Telegram, very big problem. Is better to, even the WhatsApp, and there is a option, only the admin can post the content. That kind of mechanism we are adopting, we won't get any kind of issues and all. Yeah, next tool is Plickers. This also part of assessment. I'm just to parallelly highlight the assessment tool also, because I'm not talking about the assessment tools. Yeah, the assessment tools, some of the tools are already familiar. QSIS, Plickers, Kahoot, Socrative. There is a two application in the online. One is called Socrative Teachers, other one is called Socrative Students. So Socrative Teachers, as a host, you can use the Socrative Teachers. Suppose the students want to be joined, they can install Socrates students app only. These are the tools you already familiar, like QSIS, the QSLET applications are there. These are the assessment apps is good for the teachers community. I suggest at least you can install this app once in a week or once in a month. You can add, incorporate this kind of tool for your teaching and learning. It's called QSIS, Plickers, Kahoot, Socrative. Lot of options are like yesterday the SAR meet or highlight the HYP, as well as the Profos, then Tesmos. Lot of assessment tools are there. But the assessment is a mobile based, this kind of assessment tool is very unique. That is why I kept this one. Some of the assessment tools not in online, it's not commerce in mobile apps, but this sort of applications is commerce in mobile apps. That's why I downloaded. I put us in some categorization as assessment apps. Yes, now I'm moving to the next important task, because the 21st century classrooms make goes like this only. That is called virtual teaching, virtual reality, as well as the augmented reality. Now I'm going to do some demonstration about the augmented reality as well as the virtual reality. See here, the virtual, I hope all of you get it. What is the difference between augmented reality? Augmented reality means it's a blending the two layer. What is a blending the two layer? We need a real layer as well as the artificial layer. If you're blending the two real layer, it's called as an augmented reality. For example, in my home, I want to purchase some kind of sofa set. Okay, so if you go with some shops like this kind of shops, no, the big shops and all, they have the WhatsApp, they have the this kind of augmented reality app. Just to open it, they may come to our home, they may scan our places. Immediately it shows that what color is more apt for that, what is the size is needed for your home. Everything it may suggest to the that creators. So that kind of mechanism is called as augmented reality. Augmented reality combine of two layer. One is called real layer as well as the artificial layer. Just I'm going to demonstrate the augmented reality. See here, in front of me, I kept the 100 rupees note. In front of me, I'm kept the 100 rupees note. Just I'm coming with mobile view. I'm opening the AR. This much application is good for AR, but still some of the research is going on to convert all of our textbook in the AR mode. For the demonstration purpose, I am showing some augmented reality images now. I'm going to Safari Center. It's not be higher education oriented, but we can easily use this kind of tools for children's. So the children's may happy while seeing this kind of tools. See here, I'm opening the Safari Center tool. Once I click the Safari Center tool, it's opening the one screen. So default, there is a 5 or 6 animals are there. For example, there is a 6 animals. I want to get animals in my home itself. Now I'm going to create animals in the home itself. If I click the animals in the elephant, automatically our mobile camera is open. Keep the 100 rupees old note. I'm keeping the 100 rupees old note in down. I'm just scanning the 100 rupees old note now. See here. Now the elephant is comes to my screen. See here. Now the mobile view. So you may hear the sound also. Yeah, this is called as an AR. So I'm keeping 100 rupees. See here in the 100 rupees old note. It may work with 100 rupees old note only, because this tools is developed more than 5 years before. That time they want to get some unique layer. Yeah, now the elephant is walking. See here, the elephant is walking with my laptop. The elephant is walking my laptop. Yeah. So for creating this kind of layer, we need a 100 rupees. It may working with 100 rupees old note, not near new note. Just I'm going back and coming with another animal. Suppose I want to show this animal to my students. Just I'm clicking the image, it may loading. Once it's loaded, only the camera may open. Now the camera is open. Now the camera you can turn up near to your 100 rupees. Now I'm keeping the, yeah, see here. The tiger is coming. The tiger is coming. So because I'm projecting the laptop, you know, that's why it's there. You may get 2 or 3 layers there. So otherwise only one layer, see here only one layer. This is called as an augmented reality. Very soon all our textbook may convert as the AR. Still we are, even Tamil Nadu textbook and Kerala textbook, what are they doing now? Each textbook, particularly the school textbook, up to the 8th standard, 9th standard, what they doing? They put the QR code for each page. QR code for each page. If they click the QR code, if they scan the QR code with the Diksha app and all, there's a, for example, the particular page having the poem, immediately the poem with animated videos is coming and playing. From there, the students are parsing the exact meaning of the poem and all. So this kind of application is good for the students committee. It may make the classrooms more lively also. And just I'm going back with this tool. Just I'm going to talk about the other tools. It is good for the higher education also. Yeah, so it should be. That is called Anatomy 4D app. I'm keeping the that tool, paper in bed down. I'm keeping in front of the tool. Just I'm opening the tools now. That tool name is called Anatomy 4D. Now this tool is not available in the Google Play Store. You can download directly from there only, where you can download from browser only. Just I'm opening the Anatomy 4D. If you're opening the Anatomy 4D, they're opening the camera only. So it's opening the camera. I'm opening the camera. This kind of images you can download from the library. If you go to the right corner, there is a target library. The target library, this much of images, two images they given is a free. Just take a printout of normal. Then after that, take a paper in front of you. Take the paper in front of you. And now just I'm going back and opening Anatomy 4D. So I'm opening the Anatomy 4D. The camera is open. I'm keeping the camera in the paper down. See here, I'm keeping the paper in the paper. Yeah, so now the third layer. Yeah, so suppose I am, everything's enabled now. Disabled now. I'm enabling all the things. Yes, so I'm enabling. The third layer is coming. The third layer is coming now. So here, suppose I want to teach only the skeleton. Just I'm selecting, remove the all other things and all. Okay, I need only the skeleton only. I have to talk to a student, the circularity gestures. So I remove the all the systems now. Muscle system, only the nerve system's coming. Now I want to explore only the circulatory system. Actually, the circulatory system, that things I can explain to our students. Like that, you can, for example, this here, male body. If you want to change as a female, this female body is coming. If you want to explain the things to the students, reproductive system, click the reproductive system and explain it. It's a male body. Then respiratory system. Which things you want to be highlight your students, you can use this kind of mobile apps to share your idea to our students. So different, this tool is very unique. So here the free men are adopting only this tool only. The next tool, already the e-passala we know, but recently over 5 or 6 months before e-passala AR apps is to be generated. It may work with our textbook, NCERT textbook, but we need NCERT textbook. In my hand, no NCERT textbook. Now they make it only for 9th standard textbook content, only for few content. Very soon, within a year, the entire textbook of NCERT may convert as an AR. For example, if I go with class, I'm selecting the 10th standard. The 10th standard, I'm going subject, there is a biology subject. If I go with chapters, there is a chapter 6. If I go with topic, there is only one figure in the topic. If I go with the topic, if I click or go, it come for the entire things. This is an image. This image textbook, for example, the textbook with me in front. After loading this one, only the camera may open. In the camera, what you have to do, just keep the camera in the above the textbook. But I don't have the textbook now. See here, the camera is open now. Just I am keeping the camera in the textbook, then immediately it may be scanning. But I don't have the camera. If you scan it automatically, you may get the 3D experiences. You may get the artificial layer. I hope you may get what is my augmented reality. Augmented reality means blending the real layer with artificial layer. Previously, I'm using Safari Central. The real layer is 100 rupees note. What is the artificial layer? The artificial layer is nothing but our that image. You may get the elephant, no? That is called artificial layer. Now the augment is another application. Plenty of 3D features are available. I'm going with augment. See the screen, you can see augment. If I click augment, just I'm showing, for example, I have the trending. I'm clicking the trending option. I want to get some dogs in my room. If I click dog, so in the room, so I'm keeping the camera in my home floor only. Now it should be loading. See here, the home, the dog is coming. So the dog is coming. So just you can look on it. So it may comes. Yeah, it may comes a very big screen. Yeah. So I'm going with another suppose I want to show the car and all. Yeah, suppose I want to Audi this car. Just is loading. In my home itself, there is an Audi car is coming. See here that Audi car. If I want to change the color of the color, I'm going with the yellow color. I'm going with the yellow color if you need a blue color. So it feels that in my home, that car is standing. That kind of experience may get it. So here the plenty of augmented reality things they given images. Even the recently the Google 3D. If you Google with the Google 3D, you may find the Google 3D videos. It may work with Samsung mobile. The latest version of Samsung mobile or latest version of your mobile, it may be working. If you open the 3D browser, it may automatically open. For example, here one more, just I'm going to highlight, even the education things are those there, but still now the education content is not there. Very soon they may upload the education as a category. Lot of options are there. For example, natural animals, if I go with natural animals, I want to get elephant once again here. I can click elephant. Yeah, see, in my home is down. There is an elephant is coming. The elephant is coming in down in my home. Yeah. So if I keep it properly, it may comes properly. Yes. Now, this is called as an AR app. I'm highlighting all the AR apps also. And the next is called VR. VR means virtual reality. For passing the virtual reality, we need this kind of box here. This is called virtual reality. For pursuing the virtual reality, we need this kind of VR boxes. In the virtual reality, no need for real layer. 100% should be virtual layer. 100% should be virtual layer. From this, we can perceive the things. That is called virtual layer. Yeah, so now it's nearly 5:25. Just I'm going to little, I'm going to highlight the apps only. I could not be explore the apps now hereafter. See here, I'm going to talk about the assessment apps for the mathematics apps. Those who are mathematics background or science background, for engineering background, for them it's very good app that is called MathWay, MathAnswer, MyScript Calculator, MalMath, SciMath, because I'm basically mathematics. That's why I'm using this much of applications for my teaching. Suppose if you are science background, you can find out which application is good for to the students. Just I'm going to explore MathWay. If I click the MathWay, plenty of features are available. See here, I'm just opening. Normally, it's open as a statistics. It's give the hint also. This much, if you want to go with pre-algebra, algebra, trigonometry, pre-calculus, finite math, linear algebra, with you want. Suppose I need you only the algebra. If I go with algebra, the algebraic representation comes. You can ask the questions. Even you can scan. For example, there is an option called camera. If you open the camera may open. I'm scanning the questions. I'm just scanning the question. One question is called 5x plus 8 equal to 3. I'm scanning the questions. So just I'm, it's not coming straightly. I think blurring. It only comes, I think. You see, 5x plus, yeah, see here. The 5x plus 8. I'm scanning 5x plus 8 equal to 3. The answer is coming. The answer is x equal to minus 1. So if you go with tab more option, I can see the that graph. If I click the graphic representation of the these questions is coming. So very easily we had to teach the mathematical concept to our students. So it may capturing the handwritten script. The answer may comes immediately. Even if you go with login, you can type the log 10. If you want to log 10, log 10, log 10, log 5. Okay. So which you want, you can click the log 5 too. We may get that answers. So you can explore it. Due to the time factor, I will not be highlight the features of the functions. I can share the screenshot in the WhatsApp group or the Telegram, the entire applications screenshot. You can install it. You can install it and you can explore by yourself. Next is called MathAnswer, MyScript Calculator, Max, MyMath, MalMath, and all. This for mathematics people. For the language people, those who are, it's not only for the English people. Even for the language people, for the Marathi or any kind of languages, Hindi and all, you can adopt it. Push, Duolingo, Nudge.me, Memorize, Sentence Maker, Babbel, and Drops. These are the applications good for strengthening the vocabulary skills in the particular language. Even all, most of the tools is to be based on the gamification mode. So from the gamification mode, you can organize the things and all. Next, so I hope I will share these things. Don't worry. Then next, M. Kandan. Some people have already talked about which video making contents to be good. So I'm suggesting the Powtoon and Plotagon. Just I'm showing the Plotagon video, how we can make the Plotagon video. And this kind of video, we may get it very easily. Plotagon video, see here. There is in, yeah. So we can write the text in down. So see here, I'm writing the text in down. Based on the text, you can select some of the images only, the particular people's images. Then after that, you can play with this. Then immediately it may comes for the, so yeah, now it's asking the money for this because I'm using the paid version editing things. If I go with the free version, I'll get the new plots. I'm going with the new one. I'm creating a background. This for the background scenes. I'm selecting any background which you want. Like that, there is a character. We can select the character. Then in down, we can type. There is an option called EA. We can type the text. Then finally, we can convert as in video. Like animated video, we can make this kind of animated videos very easily. That is tool is called Plotagon. So I'm skipping this one. Plotagon is a tool. Then next tool is Powtoon. The Powtoon also same feature. So we can make it this kind of animated video. Just I'm showing one video now, the Powtoon. You can upload the media, record the voice over our Play Store. Once already share the things, we can play it also through this. Just I'm opening. So I'm creating the classroom as here one video now. Yeah, so it may playing like an animated video. Here, see here, there's a classroom. I make it. I'm giving the voice. This is my voice. There is an interaction between the teacher and students. Like that, we can create an interactive video. So very simple. Just you can type a word. Automatically, it may converted as a voice. Suppose if you want to give your own voice, also you can give it. Suppose I'm making another video. Just I'm showing it to you. That is called Powtoon. For making the video in a animated. So normally Screencastify and Screencast-O-Matic only the screen record. Only we can make the screen record only. But here, see here, it's like animated. We can select the people's like from our end. So there's a discussion between the two other people. I'm not giving the voice. For easily we make this kind of video. And this is called as a Powtoon. Now the X recorder for making, for example, you have the PPT. If you want to develop, just I'm showing the X recorder. Here, automatically the recording option is coming. We can make it a mobile content. For example, you have the PPT with you. Just you can present it. Just I'm showing how I can make the video. One video I make it see here. I'm giving the lecture. The parallel it may capture our mobile screen also. This kind of video we can adopt it. Suppose I'm sharing this video. I'm giving the video. I'm just giving the demonstration. The voice I muted, that's why you're not getting. How to use the QR scanner with a mobile app. Suppose you want to give some tutorial how to use the QR scanner, you can demonstrate like this. So very simple, we can capture the entire thing through this QR code. This is a video I already developed. This is called X recorder, otherwise you can go with the A to Z screen recorder. Next thing, particularly for journal, normally we are depending on the journal like Scopus, Index. That journal only we are searching through online only. But if you have the tools like Research and Paperty, if you click the Research, plenty of journals we may get it. But we could not get the entire articles full paper. Only the abstract we may get it. From this we can understand what are the new areas it should be that people are doing the research. See here, I'm going with load papers. If I go with here. So still the, if I go with here, my subscribe the journals is coming. So this, I'm basically from education background. That's why I'm subscribing this much of journals. If you want to subscribe the journals from here, open it. In the right corner, there is a three dots. You may get it. Otherwise, if you go here, there is a search. Which subject you blanks to? So here, the mental health, life science, then chemistry and materials. Which subject you want? For example, I want to physics and mathematics. Click the physics and mathematics. If you click the physics and mathematics, you may find out the entire journals, articles, what are the things which recently they are doing the research. You can check the abstract only. And once you subscribe the journals, regularly we may get the update about the particular journals content. So for the research purpose, you can use these tools like Perpetuity also. Perpetuity also is for the research purpose, we can adopt it. Then for the citation purpose, we know that Mendeley and the citation maker, sometimes we are using the online tool, mobile based research, we want to download some information. For that, if you want to convert as a reference, you can use the Mendeley as citation maker. That is also good. So that's why I'm categorizing the mobile apps in different. Then this is a tool is for the animation. So previously I may use the augmented reality. No, this is good for the particularly for the science background people. If you want to show the 3D bones, so it's now it's loading. For the if you want to show the that body parts. Each part you want to be explained one by one to your students. See here, there's a muscular body. Suppose I'm going to skeleton. The skeleton, so you can rotate the 3D. Okay, so you can maximize it. Okay, you can explain the things with the students in a very easy manner. If I go back, I'm going with the muscular system. The muscular, lot of things are the circular system. I want to go with only circular system. Circulatory system, only circulatory system is coming. Digestive system, if you click, only the digestive system is coming. Which one you want, you can be explain the things to the students community. This is good for the science background people. So I'm suggesting those with science background, you can adopt these tools, animated content. And it's called 3D bones and organism, humans anatomy and visual autonomy, then cell word as well as the atom physics. Even for the physics people, the atom physics is good. Here they may get the some atom physics people. So they may get the what is atoms modeling test. So I'm going with the nuclear decays. You go with nuclear decays, so atoms. I'm not familiar with this. So if you select, it may come. So which one you want. So you can select the things and finally the report it may come. So the entire chart is coming here. Because I'm not familiar with physics, that's why I could not be explained much about this one. Those who are physics, they may understand what it will be running. Here we can put the A, how many A is needed, hemoglobin. That kind of things you may give, you may get the final responses. This set tools is good for these the physics background people. I'm going to talk about the photo edit. Those who are very much fond to take a photo, if you want to edit something with the photo, you can go with Snapseed, Lightroom, and Photoshop Express. These are the applications good to making the photo very colorful. Only for editing option, with editing option based that mobile apps. So I have a lot of application, but if I talk, it takes much time. So I hope it's nearly 5:30. We have to keep the time properly. I'm going to wind up the entire lectures. I will share this PPT and I will tell you how we can access the entire materials. I will tell you. So here more than 100 slides are there, 130 slides are there related to mobile apps. Just I'm come for my final slide. Yes. So actually in this 21st century, we need a 3 Qs. One is called IQ, other one is called EQ. Then third Q is called DQ. If you are getting the 3 Qs, only we may succeed in our life. So these are 3 Qs is important for the teacher community, IQ, EQ, and DQ. We already having the IQ because recently we are taking as a teaching job. Then EQ is that because recently you are attending the lot of webinar and you are sitting 3 o'clock to up to 5:30 without any things to, without any stress and all. Only the problem with DQ, if you are enriching your DQ, surely damn sure you are the great teacher in future. Therefore, the digital quotient, if you have the 3 Qs like IQ plus EQ with the DQ, 100% damn sure that you are the successful teachers in the life. It's equal to the Wi-Fi plus food plus my bed. So if you get the 3 things in your life, no? Wi-Fi plus food plus my bed. It's give the happiness to our life. The same thing, if you have the IQ, EQ, and DQ, surely in our teaching field, we may get the success. Now the program is, they conduct in a CyberGogi. Therefore, I'm going to wind up with what is a CyberGogi. Actually, CyberGogi, still now we are know the term pedagogy, pedagogy, ketogogy. The heterogogy, like the lot of gogies are there. But what is with CyberGogi? The CyberGogi means it's a central element of CyberGogi is that intent to combine the fundamentals of both pedagogy as well as the andragogy to arrive at the new learn approach to the learning. is nothing but learning through the virtual environment. CyberGuagi focus on helping adults and young people to learn by facilitating and technologically enabling learner-centered autonomous and collaborative learning in a virtual environment. Particularly the best example, we are learning the course through Coursera, edX, and MOOC. If the people's learning through this kind of mode, everything learning, teaching happened through the virtual mode or the online mode, that is called as a CyberGuagi. So now the pedagogy, now the entire world is turned towards the CyberGuagi only. So I congratulate the organizing committee member to use the term CyberGuagi, because the best example of CyberGuagi, because they are providing the CyberGuagi techniques to the entire teaching community. So I hope you know what is the meaning of CyberGuagi. Engaging the learning reflects a systematic approach to online learning. Now, that before come to my conclusion, just I want to give this some acknowledgement. So one more image is there. We know the World Crow. That story we know, but still you are adopting the World Crow story. We are not updating. So because now the crows knows how to drink it. Okay, so if you are adopting to put the stone and drink the water, it takes much time. So if you are adopting the different new tools, it's easy to flourishing the classrooms. The same thing mechanism, we can adopt it. Try to do today's job with today's tool. Kindly use the today's job for today. Don't use the old tool for the today's classroom transactions. So I have to give this much thanks to this much people. Thanks to the Google search engine, Google image, because I get it that images on my PowerPoint somewhat colorful. I get it the entire thing from the Google search engine, Google images. Thanks to them, then thanks to the slide shares, and I'm using some most images from the Pixabay website only. Thanks to them. And thanks to the website and mobile apps creator, because today I may talk about a lot of website as well as the mobile apps. But in this juncture, I want to share my thesis. Thanks to them. Thanks to the reference author. Particularly, I'm highlighting the terms IQ, EQ, and all. For them, I learned some of the things from the textbook only. Thanks to them. Thanks to the MS Office PowerPoint. And thanks to my teachers, particularly Professor Srinivas sir, because he's the well-known, he's a father of the Moodle, the entire country. So from his only, we are getting some input related to the technology and all. Thanks to him for giving the platform to us. And thanks to my students and thanks to my colleagues, thanks to my family member, particularly the Jishna ma'am as well as the Patel sir and all the organizers. I could not be pointed out the names of each one. They are doing a wonderful thing. So all the best to all of them. And finally, I share my sincere thanks to all the participants for your passive as well as the active participants in the entire program. Because I have to share my materials to all of you. That my blog ID, I'm sharing my blog ID. My blog ID is CyberGuagi. So my blog ID is CyberGuagi Tiago. CyberGuagi Tiago blogspot. I request some participants kindly type the chat box my URL ID, then other people may get it. CyberGuagi Tiago.blogspot.com. CyberGuagi Tiago.blogspot.com. If you enter it, you may get entire my materials. More than 65 contents, 65 to 70 contents are available. If you go with the mobile apps, so in down, if you come with the mobile apps, so if you, I put categories of tools in a different heading, like gamification tools, plugins tools, interactive presentation tools, web tools, digital pedagogy, and all. If you go with more posts, you may find out the mobile apps for teaching. That is the thing I'm talking here, mobile apps for education. If you click, you may find out my mobile apps tools. All the mobile apps tools are available. So mobile apps for M assessment, mobile apps for discussion forum. So everything is available. This for mobile apps. Even some of the subject specific tools also is there. Due to the time constraint, I'm not emphasizing. If you click it, you may find out the things. Then the previously I may talk about these the other tools. No, that tools description may comes the gamification. If you click the gamifications, you may get the other things like what is my gamification. So other tools like gym kit, how to organize a gym kit, the step-by-step instructions are there. So how to create a gym kit. So here, if you go with gym kit, the sign-up process, from the sign-up process to the end process, everything they deal with. So everything it will be available. So you can see that my blog itself, you may get the self-explanatory materials. Then I can talk about how to create the training quotes. So training quotes, how to create the training quotes presentation, because I already mentioned it's a flashcard. you can use this kind of step-by-step instruction for making the 10 records. If you come to down MOOC widgets, Socrative, Kahoot, every application I put us in some categorizations, from this you can be get it, okay? Because due to the time concern, I'm not able to explain everything. I hope all of you get it something from this workshop. Now I'm going to stop my screen sharing. Yeah, so I'm sharing my stop sharing. Yes, I'm stop my sharing. Yes.
Sir, I request you to quickly go through some of the queries which are raised by the participant for the second session. So it's you can check the question from Q&A session.
Yes, yes,
it is there.
Yeah, it is. Now only it's coming. Previously,
It's okay. It's okay, sir.
Yes, ma'am. So lot of questions are there. Which question I had to give the response? Can I go with the last onwards? Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes. Last okay.
Can you explain once again polls and survey? Sir, that's why I'm given my tool, my blog. Every description or that is self-explanatory. You can check it from there, because once again, I could not be, due to the time fact, I could not be explain once again these tools. Then how to train the students. It is your control only, sir. So if you are using, because compared to us, the students are very good in the technology aspects. Compared to us, the students are very good in technology. So the students are training us, especially. So for example, normally I'm giving the topic to my students only technology. They are exploring some new things. They are sharing to me. From that only I'm learning. So in this junction, I share my thanks to my students also. So no need to give the training to the students, because they are good compared to us. Only we are lacking to use the technology gadgets. If you are giving the names of the tools, damn sure they may explore by themselves. They may learn compared to us much. Then how many, is there mobile apps similar to Screencast-O-Matic? Yes, sir. So there is a mobile app. I already told, no, there is an X recorder, DU recorder, A to Z screen recorder. These are the mobile apps is good to use, like a Screencast-O-Matic or Screenmatic or OBS. So that also you can adopt it. Which tools or app uses for getting a feedback after every class? That's good. You can use these some survey tool. I already mentioned, no, the meeting files or the Slido. That kind of tool you have to use it for the feedback. Even the Flipgrid, if you want to get the, for example, now the madams are organizing this program. She want to get the feedback in a video mode. I request the organizer to get the feedback to the Flipgrid. So yes, what, sir, is the advantage, no? You can select, we can make it only one link for the Flipgrid. You can share the link to the participants. The people may give, sir, you one second or 2 minutes video, what is the feedback through the own video. Normally, if you are giving the text, we could not find out who is giving that answer and all. But it's very good. So please explain the security norms to use this. Exactly. That is why in the online, nothing's to be safe. Even if we are using the Google, we are not paying anything, but we are using more than 20 years of Google. Whether they're asking any money, because we are using a Google without paying any money. From our data only, they are running the Google. So they are getting what is the resources? For example, what are things you are searching regularly? That is the data they save. Their data they are using for some big data analysis and all. From there, they are generating the money. So that is why here, if you come for online, that safety is very less. Even if you are using the Google, no, what are things you are using the Google? It will be automatically saved in their server. So nothing should be safe. The better to be used in here. Proper manage the online tools. Particularly, that's why I'm suggesting that don't use your personal mail or personal mobile number at any kind of online tools. Whenever you're using online tools, don't give your personal mobile number. Create a separate mail ID and use a separate mobile number for connecting this kind of online tools and all. Then the chemistry people suggest, sir, actually I'm basically from mathematics. I could not be find out the exact chemistry things. So if it time chance, if it possible, I will share you. I don't know exactly the chemistry background tools, because I am based in mathematics. That's why I'm exploring my subject basic tools. So if I have the chance, if I found somewhere, I will share you. Don't worry. What is the link of Telegram? So that's, yeah. Please share the link. I already shared the link. The link of my tool is, blog ID is cybergogi.thiago.blogspot.com. There you may find out the entire thing. The language assessment tools, I already mentioned, language assessment tool to be strengthening the vocabulary skills, as well as the each day they are giving like a gamification mode. They are organizing that tools and all. Once you log in, you may understand how it will be working. Yes, so name of the application, the three-layer arguments. So I'm talking about a lot of augmented reality applications. So once again, I'm telling the Safari Central, then Anatomy 4D, then if you want to just once again, I'm showing the screen of mobile. My mobile is coming now for you.
Sir, Avogadro.
And your voice is not, hello.
So there is one application and it has compatibility with Windows also, that is Avogadro. And for chemistry teaching, it can be used.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So please, if you know, other people can know, like actually normally education, 1+1=3. So basically 1+1=2 only, mathematical context. But in education, 1+1=3. Why? In the sense, my idea, now the Bhumika madam is given one idea. If you are merging the two idea, we can generate the third idea. Therefore, 1+1=3 in the context of education. So, but it's normally is wrong in the mathematical concept, but in the education context, don't keep your knowledge with yourself. Kindly share your knowledge to others. So if you are sharing your knowledge to others, your idea plus their idea, if they mingle with that idea, they may generate a new idea. So I hope I may give some responses for your questions. And I have the question, we are constantly talking about the tech-savvy education research, but how far we prepare this global crisis keeping in the view of difficulty part of the learners and teachers with respect to incorporating technology in the Indian classroom. So your question somewhat to be psychology. So I'm not that much of psychology background. And this question, you can ask the psychology background question, but even though the technology you're using, that's why I'm suggesting that don't use much technology. Use the technology like a salt. For example, if your food is, why the taste you are perceiving the food in the sense, if you're adding the appropriate level salt only, we are perceiving the quality of the food. If you're adding much salt, we feel that what is the food like this. Then if you are adding less salt, we don't like the food. So the same mechanism you can adopt it. Try to add appropriate level of technology for adding, for transacting the content. Damn sure the classrooms will be more like the students also more interactive. That is the thing. That is why now the people must to learn TPACK strategy. I hope all of you know about the TPACK, technological pedagogical content knowledge. Based on the content, based on the pedagogy, we may adopt the some tools like so if you know the pedagogy, surely you may select the proper tools. Yes, so any other queries? I hope I may give some answer for your questions.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. It was really a very informative, insightful, and even thought-provoking session. I'm sure the participant must have found it useful and most relevant in the current scenario. Sir, I'm happy to share you with that your session is being watched by more than 500 participants through Zoom and 200 participants through Facebook live session. And you have got 245 comments on Facebook and many shared, live shared from the Facebook. Now, many participants have the query regarding the feedback form and certificate. So now I request Dr. Jyotsna Amin to provide detail about the feedback form and certificate. Dr. Jyotsna Amin.
Thank you, Bhumika. Now, regarding the feedback form, those who are on the Zoom platform, it has already been posted on the chat box by Ms. Sefali Dhimar. Those who are watching us on Facebook, it is already posted on the Facebook comment box. Those who are on the Telegram. So in Telegram also, the link of the Google form is being shared by Ms. Shefali. So you can, now all the platforms are covered with the feedback form. And this feedback form is open for 5 hours from 6 o'clock. So till 11 p.m. it will be open. You can fill in the feedback form. Tomorrow you will receive a link for the certificate. So don't worry. All those who have attended sessions will definitely get the certificates. When you get the link for the verification for the certificate, whatever you are writing, your name, designation, everything will be as it is. So please fill up those details carefully. and please fill up your email ID very carefully. So these are the two instructions. One more thing, many of them, they are asking about the video sharing. So we have already shared a link of our YouTube channel, which we have recently launched, Department of Education. So you can follow, subscribe to our channel. You will definitely see all the, both the days video uploaded within short time. Thank you, Dr. Bhumika.
Thank you, Dr. Chotsna. Now we are towards the ending of our session. And now I request Professor Sujata Srivastava, Professor, Department of Education, Associate Coordinator, the IUCT, to propose a vote of thanks.
Sujata, can I take 1 minute? Yeah. Dr. Thiyar Bhusuri, I think really, you know, we are overwhelmed and really thank you so much. Of course, Professor Sujata will thank you. But I must say that you have conducted a session of at least 7 days in just 2.5 hours' time. So this means that, you know, for such kind of topic, I think webinar is fine. This is just to bring about awareness. But now to develop their skill in real sense, I think we need face-to-face mode workshop kind of interaction. And I'm sure that it, after the situation becomes normal at the MS University of Baroda, I will invite you and I will also invite many other people like you, and we will have perhaps 7 to 10 days workshop wherein we will try to ensure that each participant develops the skill. And then once you are able to develop the skill, you will be able to use it. So yes. With this, yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Sujata, ma'am, over to you. Hello, Sujata, ma'am.
Yeah. Actually, there's some disturbance in the audio is coming.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Bhumika. I take this opportunity to first and foremost thank our Honorable Vice Chancellor of the Maharaja Sayajirao University of Baroda, Professor Parimal Vyas, who was with us yesterday, and he took time off his heavy schedule and he shared the space with us yesterday. So my heartfelt thanks goes out to him. My very sincere thanks to our resource persons. Yesterday we had Dr. V.P. Joshit from Nagaland University, from the Department of Teacher Education, Kohima Campus, Kohima. And today we had Dr. Vyal Tyagu, and he gave a wonderful session. Both of them have really, you know, fulfilled us more than our expectations that we had. And friends, let me share with you that they are very, very busy people, really in demand, you know, going and giving, conducting so many webinars in their area of expertise. So thank you, both of you, so much for sharing the space with us. Thank you so much. My sincere thanks to our organizing committee members, Dr. Jyotsna Amin, Dr. Bhumika Barot, Dr. Bhavin Chauhan, and our research scholar, Shefali Dhimmar. Friends, let me share with you that they have been deeply involved in planning and organizing this webinar. So my sincere thanks to the whole of this organizing team. 3 cheers for them. Thank you, IUCT team, for your assistance. And thank you, Dr. Arunanand, for your excellent technical support. We really couldn't have done without you. Ladies and gentlemen, this webinar has been organized under the dynamic leadership of Professor R.C. Patel. And let me share with you that Professor R.C. Patel has this great quality of encouraging and supporting all academic initiatives. So we feel that we are blessed to have leadership like him in our own Department of Education and Faculty of Education and Psychology, the Maharaja Sayajirao University of Baroda. Thank you so much, Professor Patel. On behalf of the Inter-University Center for Teachers Education, Department of Education, Faculty of Education and Psychology, the Maharaja Sayajirao University of Baroda, I thank all the participants for being with us yesterday and today and for spending their valuable time. We sincerely hope that it has been worth it for you. Thank you Namaskar till we meet again.